You Know What Do podcast on riotcast.com.
All right, guys, what's up? This is Paul Virzi here, and I am co. No, not co. I am.
No, you're guest. Me.
I keep saying, everybody's saying, are you co? And I'm like, no, I'm fucking Bobby today. I was here last week for an amazing one with, who was on it?
Anthony Cumia. Yeah. We had Casey Balsham.
And we got into it, and it got a little political and nuts, but fun. Mm-hmm. And then
really? With Anthony Cumia? Shocking.
And then they asked me to do this, and I'm thrilled to be here, and I have you, Deepu. I have a co-pilot here.
Yeah, Paul is so excited to have a producer in the studio as opposed to just like someone he emails. Yeah.
Dude, I've been doing my podcast for 6 years, and when I fuck up, it's like I just either have to, you know, I have to stop everything or I have to go back. I have to make sure it's recorded, and it's always me.
Dude, every listener knows when you hear Lloyd, there's a pause after that,
Come back. Yeah, the middle of my podcast, like people like that, though.
Yeah, it's great.
They were like, don't take it out. So my dog, Lloyd, I would be in the middle of like some fucking rant or something. Yeah. I'd be like, Lloyd,
it's like epic.
You fuck it. And everyone's like, you got to keep that in there. So I'm either yelling at my cats, my kids, and my dog during it. But here I have Deepu. Deepu, and we also have amazing guests. One is also coming. Do you want to?
Yeah, our first guest today is Alexis Guerreros.
What up, everybody?
Of Cooligans fame.
That's right.
Yeah. Cooligans blowing up.
Does everyone
up.
Like soccer? Please stop calling me gay. I can hear it already.
All right, we lost listeners already.
Yeah, I said soccer.
Who likes soccer? They were like, yeah, I can't.
I think I'm listening to a European podcast or something weird.
They're like the Super Bowls this week. What's going
I can't
on?
Do it yet.
We also have Luchana Gatica in the studio.
Yeah. Luchana Gatica.
For pronouncing my
two
name
Latinos.
Is it?
I know.
Luchana.
Luchana. Yes.
Luchana. And where are you from?
Well,
your family.
Chilean, Irish, German. So half Chilean, half Irish. German.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Do you go to Chile?
I haven't since I was a little girl, but I want
that. You're not
to
allowed
be my...
to anymore.
I know.
So, part of the band.
I don't know if I'll be let back in.
Yeah. I think
you're too brown.
I'm going to postpone that trip for another 4 to 8 years. Hopefully 4.
And we also have Yannis Pappas joining us later on in the show today.
Yannis, my good friend who I ran into last night and always stay out way too late. Yannis is one of those guys, like, you know, Yannis and I are close, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And, well, like us, like, but when I see Yannis, I know. I remember back in the day, Burr would say every time I saw DeRosa, we would just go, fuck. Because we knew it meant that they were going to be out.
It's an all-nighter.
And that's kind of what's happening with Yannis now, because we both smoke the cigars and we both like to, you know, go out, hang, shoot the shit. We always end up at a diner.
Right.
And it turns in, and I have an hour drive home. And I'm like, no, if I leave at 1:30, then I'm like, wow, it's 2.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, dude, it's 3. I'm going to get home at 4. And it's always a fucking nightmare. So sometimes it's good when you don't see those people.
Yeah.
But you, I just found out. Yeah. Aren't going to no longer be smoking the sticks for a while.
Just for a little bit.
All right.
My wife works at a cancer hospital.
All right.
And she just got some whole thing that says it's like smoking 15 cigarettes. And I'm like, nah, baby. I'm like, the first thing I said, I was like, you can't prove that. I'm like, where are you getting this information? And she's like, you idiot. I work in the cancer hospital in the world. I'm like, oh, yeah, good point.
That means Bobby Kelly smokes.
Yeah.
Bobby Kelly must smoke fucking 4 packs of cigarettes a day.
He smoked one tobacco farm yesterday.
Yeah. Yeah.
I thought you don't inhale. I don't
you
know
do not.
How to smoke
you don't,
cigars.
But the smoke, still, oh, you want to pull the smoke back and out. And essentially, it travels through your esophagus so much that it's the equivalent of, because it's so big.
I will tell you this. Luciana's right about something, because I went to my doctor and I was like, look. You know, my wife is giving me shit. My wife gives me shit about it. Because I love a stick. You know, I mean, I'll smoke fucking. I love to smoke a good
dude,
cigar.
Dude, if I smell like cigars, D'll say, be like, you were hanging out with Virzi today, weren't you?
And yeah.
Like, yeah.
So I guess they say that the main smokers in the comedy scene in New York would be myself, Aaron Berg.
Who just quit.
Bobby. No, I saw him yesterday outside smoking.
He says he's quitting.
Oh, I hope I didn't ruin it. Yeah, I just put him on blast. Yeah, his fucking girls listening like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
No, he did quit, as a matter of fact.
Yeah. Oh, no, he wasn't smoking.
Wink, wink.
No, so it's Berg, myself, obviously Bobby, Yannis. I would say you're probably like tier two.
I'm second level.
You're second level, but you're still in the category.
Yeah, I'm in the game.
And you want to know what's funny about it is when you go on the road, like, even when I was in Canada, I was performing in Canada, and they were like, what's this whole thing with, like, New York comics smoking cigars now? Like, people see us doing that.
Yeah, I'm from L.A., and no one does that there.
Of course like, not, because it's not organic.
Well, yeah,
you know?
That's true.
But,
I've never.
Can I get a free-range cigar? Is that possible?
Do you have, like, an electric cigar, maybe?
They do,
actually,
by
they're
the
actually
way.
Making
they
that
do?
Shit. Yeah,
oh,
it's
my
weird.
God.
It's embarrassing.
It's embarrassing.
What?
Dude, you know what? Since
I'd rather get cancer before I smoke a
100. I'd be like 15 cigars. Oh, no. I don't give a shit.
Yo, an e-cigar is just like, dude, either smoke a fucking stick or not.
Yeah, yeah.
Or don't. Yeah.
Stand next to the guy smoking the cigar. You don't need to be out there with that electric cigar. Right, guys? Right, fellas? Let me know when we're all done so I can unplug my cigar.
Isn't that just like a vape?
It's blue. Yeah. It's like a blue fucking flame or green.
It's plugged into your fucking dashboard.
That's so let's do this. Let's talk about this. This is what I want to talk about. It's actually good that we have, because I've been talking to people about this a lot. Now, how long have you been in the New York comedy scene now?
It'll be 3 years in March.
3 years. I remember you when you were first got here. I saw you at Gotham, I believe.
That was, I wasn't even going to move here. You were like one of the people who he was like the first comic I met here in New York. And he was like, you should move here. I was like, nah.
Because you came from the LA scene.
Yeah.
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 And I always wanted to live here, but then I just kind of gave up on it in my late 20s. I was like, I'm not moving across the country. I'm not going to like winter and shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
And And I was just visiting. That was my first time.
And it was Juice, right?
Yeah. It was Juice, yeah. Comedy Juice. And great show. It was like in October of like 2013. And then, yeah, I remember you talking to you. You're like, you should move here. Like, you would do really well. And I was like, I don't know. Like, I don't think so.
Can't believe he lied to you.
Well, that's what
I know. It's all your fault. Now I'm here.
She's like, so I'm begging for money.
Talking into a saliva-filled microphone.
Yeah, you ruined it. Smells like now I'm like slobber. Staying out.
I won't go near this thing.
I'll get Febreze.
I got fucking Bobby.
Yeah, Febreze is going to kill the bacteria. Don't even worry about the
this
Febreze.
This thing is fucking infested with Bobby breath. Yeah.
You smelling that? That's 15 cigarettes on its own.
I wish it did smell like cigars. Yeah. So now I guess this is the thing. A lot of people, when people go out to Los Angeles, it's either hate. Like a lot of people just hate it. Like a lot of East Coast are just like, nah. Yeah. You know, and I was out there visiting, you know, I went out there for I performed at the Orpheum. I opened for Burr on New Year's Eve. Me and my wife went out there.
I heard that show was incredible.
That show was crazy. Yeah. I'm not gonna lie, that show was crazy.
Yeah.
And it was me, Bartnick, Lawhead Burr. It was a four horseman. It was fucking awesome.
On New Year's Eve.
On New Year's Eve. Yeah. At two shows. But my wife, we're driving around and my wife is like, I can't live here, you know? But I feel like this is just me. When I was in LA the first time, I was like, I get the weather. I get the sights. The sights are beautiful. Like seeing the mountains and shit. Like it's cool. It's nice.
Dude, I drove to San Diego. I was like, this is ridiculous.
It's a beautiful landscape. The weather is great. I also like that it gets a little cold at night because of the desert. But I didn't love it. But then my second time going, I stayed for like a week and something about it changed. I was like, I kind of like it. I kind of like the fucking helicopters flying around. I kind of like the weather. I kind of like it. And then I noticed I miss it. But I will say this. I think I can do it like 2 week increments or a month. I just don't know. Yeah. I don't know. I got kids. I love the seasons and shit.
Yeah.
But not that matters. But I think it's cool for my kids to have fucking snow.
Yeah. Yeah, no, 100%. It makes you a better person. No offense. Yeah.
I don't know about a better person.
No, I do. I think it does. No, because if you have fucking perfect weather all year round, there's something wrong with your head. Yeah. You never get that time off. You don't get that snow, I can't go outside. You don't miss people. You know, like the first week of spring in the city? That's the fucking greatest week.
All right,
week.
So let's say this. Let's say it's maybe true. You're more balanced. I don't know about better.
Nah, I think it makes you a better person.
You get better DNA. Yeah. I'm telling you. You got better inside. You're a better inside. Yeah. You're just a better human being.
Maybe it's not that we're better. It's just that they're so shitty, you know, over there. It's just what it is. I think it's too much of a good thing out there. I love visiting LA because when you get out there, you're like, oh, this is great. And then a week later, you're like, all right, I get it. I can't wait to go back. And I'm not one of those guys who's like, oh, you can't get a good slice. I mean, I am that guy, actually. But, you know, that doesn't bother me. Like, the topography doesn't bother me. The geography. What really bothers me is like, and you know what it is? This time I found it's the comedians that I really like out there. It's literally everyone else in that city. That's not just like a regular dude from like Los Angeles. I'm talking like the actors, the people from their towns that consider themselves the hottest, the cutest, that go to that fucking city.
Yes.
They're just the shittiest people. I can't be around them.
Yeah.
I can't be around these stupid conversations like, so what do you do? What do you draw? I don't give a fuck about you. And I don't want
Alexis
you to give a fuck about me.
It's true.
I had a lot of coffee.
I remember meeting Paul and he was like, yeah, you should move here. And he was so nice. Like, I didn't know him, but he was like, hey, what's up? Like,
you don't get people like this in LA.
I did not expect that when I moved here.
Really?
I didn't know any comedians.
Really?
I was like, I did not expect to be embraced the way I was by the comedy community in New York City. Like, it's unbelievable, especially women, because women, like the female comedians in LA, are all like hot girls. A lot of them are my friends. If you're listening, I still love you. But a lot, they're just like hot girls, and they're like, oh my god, it's like so, like, you know, crazy, like doing stand up because I'm hot, you know.
That. And it's some like, of them are my friends. I love you, but they're like, oh my god.
No, but it's
hilarious.
Like every hot girl just yeah. thinks it's so ironic. Oh my god, I'm gonna do stand up because it's like so ironic because they're all actresses. You know what I mean? And it's like it's
it reminds
just,
me of this.
It's so crazy, and it's just also there are no like you. I see so many like lineups in LA and flyers, and none of them have a female comedian on it. And I'm like, really, guys, really? Like at the Laugh Factory, at the Comedy Store, like all of them, and here. Every show has a woman on it, you know, and
yeah.
just like the way, like I remember one of the first, I think it, Giannis actually was one of the first comedians I met too, and Chris DiStefano at the Stand. Like I was just hanging out there because people were like hanging out at the Stand, and I remember them being like, "Oh, welcome," you know, and those are people like I respect, like you know, people like you guys who are like. I met you right away, I think, yeah. you know, people that I actually respect as, yes,
yeah.
as comedians who I think are so very talented, you know, who have done great things, you guys have. And I remember, you know, them being like, hey, and it wasn't like in LA where they're just trying to bang you. It was like nothing like that. They were
no,
just actually.
Still doing that
here. I'm sure they probably.
Oh, yeah. yeah. Well, yes.
Being,
but they.
Just not being as direct about it.
They weren't in particular. They were just yeah. like, hey, welcome, you know, whatever. And then I would see them. 2 weeks later and they'd be like, hey Luchana, like how's it going, how are you liking New York, like what's going on in LA? I can't tell you, there's one comic specifically, I won't name his name, but he is such a piece of shit. Like I met him, he's well known, you guys know who he is, and he I'm sorry, I don't care how funny you are, if I've met you seven times, I've brought you up on stage before, we've done the same shows, etc., like, and you don't remember meeting me, and I just saw him at the Standing Room like a couple weeks, like a couple months ago, and he's like, hey, nice to meet you, and I was just like, I knew it, like I saw him and I was like, this fucking guy. And sure enough, and somebody like Sal, the manager of Standing Room, was like, oh yeah. Yeah. And I was like, I fucking hate that guy. Like, I knew he was going to introduce himself to me again,
yeah.
even though
I'm
I met him like
that.
6 years
yeah,
ago.
Yeah. We all thought it was
no,
first.
No, I know what you mean, though. I know what you mean. And
but that's just the difference. They don't give a shit. Like, here and, people give a shit, and they're just, you know, it's a different community.
We're
also,
better people.
But I
we're
think
just
it's
better.
Also just there are more spots here. There are more clubs here.
Well, that's what
they're,
I was going to say.
They're fighting over there, you know?
Yeah.
Like they're, and every time they see a new comic, they're like, this person's going to take my spots. We're here. It's like, hey, no, like, there's spots. For everyone, you know.
Well, one thing I think that I think here, you know, and I said this, I've said this to young comics. I remember that there's a young kid, Cody Odell. He's a newer comic out here. He's from San Antonio. I saw him work, and I go, look, you know, it's like what Chris Rock said. He goes,
you're
doesn't
like
matter.
The Godfather,
it's
just going like, up to like new
no,
comics.
Just yeah, single handedly is increasing the rent in Manhattan,
no,
in New York City.
Because
everybody's
like,
got to
hey,
move to
me. No, if I see somebody that I like, and I think I see somebody that's funny or can be funny, or somebody that's vulnerable, and I'm just like, look, man, you got. If you want to get better, I think this is no disrespect to comics in L.A. When I go out to L.A., yeah, I'll get up on like, you know, I have some people know me, so I could get up on like a weekend at the Improv. But other places don't. I'd have to get like either hookups or something. They don't know me out there.
Yeah.
But I do notice when I do perform out there and you get real on stage, or the crowd sees it differently. Like I've noticed that they're just like, oh, shit, because I don't think they're getting a lot. Now, there's definitely monsters out there.
Yeah,
100%.
There's killers out there.
There's absolute killers. I'm not going to sit here and say, but.
And there's a lot of low-key killers, people that don't get the respect, don't have that high-level buzz.
Right.
And I'm like, man, these guys are great.
But I think the New York scene, like, this is the closest I've seen to, like a Montreal Just for Laughs show, where you look at the lineup and you're just like, you know, Friday, Saturday night at the Stand.
Yeah.
You know, also when you look at Friday, Saturday night at the Cellar or the Stand and you look at them, you're just like
New York Comedy Club. I mean,
New York Comedy Club, like all of these like great clubs in New York, and there's a lot. You look at the
Comedy Juice on a Tuesday.
You look at the lineups and it's like, this is fucking, this is like, it can only get you better. But I agree with you. I don't think people are that. Listen, we all have the the competitive thing. We all have that. Why the fuck did that person get that? I want that.
For sure.
I mean, to say that doesn't exist is crazy, but and that's a human thing. That's not a geographical or a regional thing. That's a human thing, I think. But I think here it's just like everybody knows everybody's funny, and everybody just knows everybody continues to get funnier, and you just kind of just hang and like, hey man, you know, we're doing this show tonight. It's gonna be a fucking killer lineup, you know.
Yeah.
And I mean, I don't know what it's like out there as far as the people. I have friends that are out there. Some of my best friends are out in LA, and they love it, you know.
But like you're talking about more established comedians, you know what I mean? Like, you go to like when you're out there like banging it out in the clubs where no one's got anything yet. You know, the guys, you know, they've all accomplished. They're all names, you know. like, and though some of them are my friends too, but like, I'm talking about like your regular comics, the people I'm quote unquote competing with, if you will, that are on my level. You know, you go out there. I was surprised. I expected everyone to be a fucking douche. I just expected, because that's what you think of LA, you know, especially for those of us from the East Coast. You're like, oh, they're going to give me a fucking headshot, or they're going to shake my hand and look past me, all that shit. And I got to be honest, some of that happened, of course, but like, and that some of that happens here.
Right.
Some of the most incredible people, you know, but again, you know, you got to live out here.
But that's also because they know you're coming from New York, and they're like every comic in LA knows that like they can't touch comedy in New York. Like you can't.
And now that I think about it, though, the women out there that are doing stand up. Are really like attractive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now that I'm like thinking about it, and I'm just like, as I'm going through the places that I've been, I'm like, wait a minute, like, why the fuck is she
why are you
doing
on stage?
I know. Like, I'm thinking about it, and you, because you planted that seed, and now that I'm thinking about, like, I remember being at the improv, I remember walking in, and like, it's very like done up, like camera ready.
Yeah. Fucking, they all look like Real Housewives.
Like, it doesn't look like somebody rolled out of bed and like in the New York scene and walked 10 like blocks hoodies. And goes to do a fucking
You don't know if this person is going to buy their morning coffee. A cigarette and do comedy. In LA, they're done the hell up. And the funny thing is, I remember there was a female comic, I don't know her name, but she's like a legit 8 in New York, you know, probably in LA 6 or 7. She got on stage and talked about how ugly she was. The body of a model.
Who's this?
I don't know her name, but she hosted in New York.
Yeah.
And the crowd.
I am a fucking dog.
And you know, from the audience, the audience was like, there were like these 3 chubby girls from Queens. They couldn't throw more lasers out of their eyes at this girl.
Yeah,
they were just like, they had like, this like real fuck you. I'm not laughing at a fucking thing you say. And she was just like, oh, and then these pretty girls walk in and she's doing this whole thing. And we're all like, dude, that's you. What are you talking
about? Nothing is worse than when a female's on stage talking about how
so
nobody
annoying.
Wants to fuck them
it's
and
so
they're
annoying.
Fucking attractive.
Guys in the audience with their hands up.
Like,
guys like,
what
are you talking about?
No, it's the word. Like, I saw somebody recently in New York and she's like, yeah, and I'm trying to get laid. And I'm just thinking to myself, like, what?
Yeah.
You know, not that she's like, but it's like, come on. Like, don't fucking play the I can't get dick victim.
Right. Don't act like people aren't swiping right. Or I don't know if that's the good one. Yeah. Whatever the good one is. People aren't actively
swiping.
You swipe
on all of them these days.
Yeah. I don't know any of that stuff. I feel like the oldest.
I know. I've been married 10 years. Me and you are in the same boat here.
So which one are you? Are you on one?
No, I have a boyfriend now.
You have a boyfriend?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Congratulations.
Oh, nice. How long?
It'll be a year next month.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Nice. From New York?
He's actually from LA, but we met out here on a swipe situation.
Oh, you met on an app?
Yeah.
Is he in the business or no?
No.
He's not in the business.
Thank God.
Smart move.
Yeah, no,
smart
you can't.
Yeah, the main
can't.
Yeah.
I was talking to Giannis about that yesterday. We were eating a burger and I'm like, dude, I don't know how you can't like, you know.
Yeah, nah.
Just I don't think you could do it. I don't think I could ever.
Like, I couldn't be with another comic. I thank God my wife's not a comedian.
Well, no, that's what I'm saying. I think it's a really tough kind of you know thing, because no matter what, there's gonna be like, if you're like, oh, I'm going out to LA, you know, I'm going out to LA. I just got this show. There's gonna be some sort of resentment.
Yeah.
Like after a while.
Yeah.
Speaking of, it's a great Yanni's here. Yannis Pappas. Oh, this is great. This is great because we're talking about comedians dating comedians and if there is resentment in the business.
I wonder if you know anything about that,
Yannis. Yeah, Yannis, I swear
any
to
personal
God,
experience?
Dude, you came in at such a good time. It almost looked like we got all right. Cue Yannis. Cue Yannis. Get him in here. Get him in here.
Deepu
went like this to you. So let me ask you this
There's
question.
There's resentment in the business even if you're not dating.
No, but what I'm saying is this, though. If you're dating a female comic and you happen to like
that
get
means
a,
you're
get
straight
on a,
first
on a,
off
get, right.
This might be a stretch for you, but if you're dating a female comic
female
honest,
yeah, I've yeah. tried it
yeah it's not as easy as dating a male comic.
No, still prefer dudes, but
So if let's say there's a big show, I'm just for argument's sake, let's say Friday night midnight show at the Stand was like the greatest show that everybody had to get on, right? Like a JFL fucking showcase, nuts, right?
Yeah.
And you lived with a girl and you're dating and one of you get it and both of you wanted it.
Yeah.
When you go home that night, did you feel a little bit of like tension or resentment when one of you's got something like that, or
was
no? Or was it hidden? Because it definitely existed, no?
Well,
it festers.
She only got one thing. Everything else she never got. So I never had to. I never. Oh, they know. This podcast knows. Jesus, it's been.
Have you only dated one comedian?
I've dated one comedian.
You only dated one comedian.
One comedian.
Have any of you guys dated comedians?
Nah.
No.
I was married before I got in the game.
He's been married since he's been, since he,
Luciana's like, since he
rafted. Alexis has been married since he rafted over from Cuba.
The plane took me.
She was on the beach waiting for him.
Yeah. No, he
was
like, Mina, Mina.
I thought everybody got a white girl when you got here.
Kind of in LA, kind like I went on some dates with some comics, but
you slept with comics. Is what you're saying
didn't work out.
Yeah.
They just got friend zoned. It's okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Ouch.
That's, banging comics is fun though. You know, it's a great night out. You guys cracking jokes. You know, then you bang.
A lot of pressure.
Huh?
A lot of pressure.
Yeah.
For
I would feel like it would suck to do that.
No. It's but no. It's fun to bang. It's fun to hook up.
Giannis is somebody loud?
Yeah,
this is.
I think he's loud.
Bobby's not here. The whole fucking thing falls apart.
Oh, we got Deepu. That's amazing. I said it's unbelievable having this kid.
Bobby didn't leave the Deepu stick to hit him? Oh,
no. Yeah, no, there's two dildos right up there.
You got to hit him with the dildo.
Dude, Virzi looked at that dildo and was like, I ain't touching that thing.
Yeah, first I was like, no, I'm good.
Do you got, Deepu, you got papers for this fucking show, man? You better not try to go visit your relatives. You may not make it back in the country at this juncture.
My green card was valid till yesterday.
Really?
More like like deported. Am I right?
Deported.
There's your name of your first special.
Deported. Yeah.
There's the name of your first CISO special.
Yeah.
Because they're giving them to anybody.
Oh, nobody. Something nobody will see. So
Giannis coming in.
No, that's what they should call it.
Yeah, nobody sees.
Nobody sees. So.
Some, I heard somebody like. I guess,
Comedy Central should say we're airing your special and then we're hiding it forever.
You said what is it? Comedy Central is the best place.
Is
to
the best
hide
place to hide your special.
That was so.
Do you know how many comedians that I know have done hours that nobody knows who the fuck they are? Like it's almost
you can't
like
find it.
It's almost like a set. It's just like doing a set.
Yeah.
So listen,
they actually film it at an open mic.
I want to go back to this. I want to go back to this real quick. So if you hook up, because I never did this. This is foreign to me. You know, I don't know this. I've been married.
Well, you're like you're a grown up with a family and kids.
Yeah.
You're a legitimate adult.
Yeah. Like, because I fucking had sex and fucked around. It was time to. Not when I'm fucking in my late 30s. Yeah.
Listen,
you did it right.
I'm halfway to you. I'm avoiding the kids and the house and the dog.
But let me ask you something. If you got blown or if you blew, let's just say, right?
A
comedian. And then see that person the next day on a showcase. Isn't it like when you walk in the room, is it a little fuck? It's got to be a little fucking
Deepu,
weird,
is it
right?
Weird if you blew a guy and then you see the next
female comics are pretty cool about that shit.
I guess.
Unless if you rape them, then they really get after you on social media.
Well, no, then they have to, then they tell our police force, which is UCB.
Yeah.
That's our special victims. UCB SBU.
I wonder if it's got to be more weird for the woman, no?
I just like I never thought, like took any comedian situation seriously because I was just like I don't want to be a comedian because it's not going to be a good idea for anybody. But I've seen a lot of disasters from like. Comedians dating each other.
She pointed at you when she said this.
Yeah.
Subconsciously.
I've seen a bunch of.
Giannis is like the one they read in the history books. Yeah.
No, he's the point of reference.
Like the World War II. Yeah. Are you
dating a comedian seriously? Have you heard about Giannis?
Well, everybody talks about 2016 being a bad year, but, you know. You got to remember the girl code fame kind of died down, so it's a good, that's a positive. that was a silver lining. Started a slide. I think it's fallen.
You got to go to Sherwin-Williams and decide what color am I going to dye my hair now?
Well, at that time, it was me, Chrissy D. What was this, fucking 4 years ago now?
Sounds like it.
Jesus.
Yeah, it was me, Chris DiStefano, and Andy Haynes. We were all dating girl code chicks.
Yeah, so he Andy, broke up with his.
No. Andy was married.
He divorced though.
And she cheated on him. They had an open relationship, which I think I heard rumors. I'm not sure if that's positive. Wow. But no, she dumped him too after Girl Code.
Oh.
So the three of us would commiserate. We really bonded. I bonded with Andy too. We texted each other back and forth, you know.
Big Arsenal fan.
Yeah. Chrissy D caught it. Chrissy D
every
had,
time you bring up soccer, it gets nothing.
The ratings.
It's Super Bowl week, Alexis.
Question. I'm gonna listen. I am fighting so hard.
He's trying to throw in any kind of fucking soccer pun, any line, and dude, everything is just.
You have no idea.
If you knew our audience, it wouldn't be a good. You would know it's not a good idea.
I don't give a fuck.
Yeah. I've noticed that all these.
Who the fuck is your soccer guy?
Who laid a gay guy on there?
All these audiences for a lot of these like podcasts, don't they seem like they're all kind of O&A kind of spillovers? Like, you know what, dude? Mm-hmm. Legion of Skanks.
Yeah, we're all spin-offs.
Andy Kumina. It's all like all the fans.
Yeah.
Whenever you see the people tweeting at you, whenever we've brought up gun control on here, I get like just fucking 20. Fuck you. Yeah. Go debate Kumia. Yeah. Go debate him. Yeah. Get on Dave Smith's show. Yeah. Come on, pussy.
Like, sounds about right.
A lot of red votes. A lot of Staten Islanders listen to this.
Not on all podcasts. I think.
Talking about this, like this, you know, like the
vocal,
tentacles.
The vocal ones are like that.
Yeah, like they're all kind of from O&A. They're all like sort of the spinoffs of O&A for fans. Fans just.
I don't know. All I know is there's always, no matter what you do in this business, and you could, it could be great, and you'll get 25 tweets, but there'll be two. There'll be two that you're like, do I go at this guy? Yeah. You know, they'll always be like, it'll be like, oh, I loved you on that show. Oh, you did a great job. And you're like, oh, yeah. And then there's one person like, what a stupid fucking opinion. Yeah. Fuck you. Yeah. And you just, and it's so fucking over the top. And you're just like, but then you look at them and they got 9 followers.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you're like, what the, why would,
no
why
profile
am I fighting
pick.
This?
Yeah.
It's an egg.
And I've realized,
with an egg.
Yeah.
Profile a lot of pick looks like a registered sex offender.
Yeah. And it's always the third pick. Just one, like a blurry guy with a beard and glasses. Yeah. The other two. Who's like a fucking Tom and Jerry cartoon.
Yeah. Or the guys are really angry. It's a photo of their dad when they were in the army. It's always like
funny.
A picture of their like grandpa.
That's funny, yeah.
Or like an American flag and an eagle as that back picture.
The eagle has a gun and it's shooting up a school. This is America. Jesus.
But you know what I realize is a lot of
the eagles got a gun. I never heard that one before.
God damn it. You gotta fucking arm these eagles.
So if every eagle had a gun, terrorism wouldn't be a problem.
Oh shit.
You know what I've noticed? A lot of them just want you to respond. I've responded, like seriously, like Jesus, dude. Like when I just asked, like, why are you fucking? They're always like, hey man, love you, big fan, just fucking around. I'm like, you got a weird way of showing it, man.
Yeah, I don't think your mom's a faggot. Yeah, I'm just saying.
I'm just saying I'm a big fan.
I'm a big fan.
I don't want your pets dead. Yeah, I'm just, you're right.
I really don't know where you live and I don't have a gun. I'm actually just a big fan.
But it is it is hilarious. Comedians are the only ones who cannot fucking resist responding to the troll.
I do. Except, you know, I had a Sandy Hook.
But you learned
it. Yeah, I had a Sandy Hook guy because I'm doing a shoot and joke and he hit me up and I had to, there was something in me that I had to go back at the guy.
Right.
And it wasn't crazy, but no, for the most part, when people go that fucking hard or say something that they don't like, the best thing to do is to not. But you're right. I've went somebody and they're like, hey man, all love, just, you know, it's like, don't fucking come at me like
that.
Yeah,
it's like, you got a weird way.
Don't come at me that.
You got a weird way of showing it.
Yeah. I think they think
Skippy or Skeeter.
Yeah. Because we shit on each other, they think like that's how I gotta talk to them.
Yeah.
It's like, no, you're not my friend. You gotta come at me with some respect.
Not only are we not friends, we're fragile people, okay? Yeah.
We're
doing this because we need your approval deep down.
We don't do comedy because we don't have a lack of ego and need gratification.
I'm not standing up on a wood plank for fucking chicken fingers on a Tuesday night because my mom hugged me all the time.
Exactly. Don't you feel that like that goes away? Like I feel like now it's not about as much pleasing them. It's more for me a little bit now. Like I don't feel like it's as much. Like if I do it, because I used to be afraid.
Yeah.
I used to be afraid and I used to get upset when something didn't work. You know, I remember one time, a long time ago, I was in South Carolina performing. And I looked at a comment card and like this lesbian woman, I was like 4 years into comedy, 3 years maybe. And she's like, how did he win any contest? And it was like a light crowd. And I just talked to her partner.
What contest did you win?
It was a fucking, like when I was like 03, like a contest to go to like a Vegas comedy festival or something. Like that was like the only credit I had. Right.
Oh, and you got brought up. You remember those days when you whatever you're like, you heard this guy once outside of the Sirius XM building talking to another comic who was going up to be on a show.
Yeah. Well, remember your first. Yeah. Like when your first credit was Sirius and that was it. You were psyched. You were like, like you finally were like, I got one. I got one to give him.
I used to use Chappelle's show as a credit.
No.
And I was in it in the background. I was the guard I was in the background, and Donnell was like, "Yo, you got to cheat to the camera, son." He was like, "Turn out," because I was just profile. So he was like, "I cheated like three ways just so you could kind of see my face."
Yeah.
I'm like, "Wait,
I'm blurry
in the background. I'm not even in focus." So you can't even tell it's me. And I got brought up. I got brought up as you've seen him on Chappelle's Show for probably 10 years.
Your website is a screen cap.
Yeah.
You used that one last week.
I used that one last week. Yeah.
You seen this guy?
You seen this guy on Chappelle's Show? He knows co-creator. He knows friends of Dave Chappelle. Give it up.
He walked on the same sidewalk as Dave Chappelle.
Yeah. He got his makeup done while Dave Chappelle was in the room.
I used to work with a kid whose credit was Game Show Network because he was sitting just behind the contestant.
He was on for
most of the half hour.
That's great.
Because he was on in the background. I'm like, I was like, that's not a credit.
Yeah.
I'm like, but people saw me. I'm like, I guess.
So you got to do it at the beginning. You need a credit.
No.
Speaking of Jessie Mae, she had a funny one. She had a real funny one.
We were done talking about it. That's
hilarious. But I just want to bring it up.
Speaking of Jessie Mae, it's going
back. It made me think of Jessie Mae because she was on, before we started dating, she was on Last Comic Standing, but she was on the part where they make fun of you, you know, and they show that montage bombing. And then she used that as a credit for like 4 years.
But there was a period of time when they first did it that like every comic I ran into used Last Comic Standing.
Yeah, yeah.
Because when they used to do that Linescape, like they would dolly past everyone in the line, they're like, credit.
Dude, I was like 14 people back.
I'm behind the guy holding the two puppets. You see me?
No, but don't you find, I do find it like, I used to worry what they thought and if somebody would say something bad, and now it's like I almost get, maybe it's because I get defiant with it now that it doesn't bother me. It doesn't hurt me anymore. It used to hurt me.
Yeah.
It doesn't hurt me anymore if somebody doesn't.
Being honest?
I am being honest. I'm being honest. It doesn't hurt
me. So why'd you respond to that guy?
The Sandy Hook one bothered me because I looked
because
up his...
Because the guy had a good point. Children were killed. Like, you know, you got kind of a good point. I mean, they were 6 years old, so... Yeah,
I'm not going to change anything.
But his
point, I'm not going to change it, but you make a good point, you know?
I disagree. I think...
I'm joking.
No, I know, but I looked at his page, and I just saw, like, all the fucking pictures... And I wanted...
You mean his dead baby son in his arms? Just like...
He's got a credit. He's on the news holding his dead baby.
So this guy... Oh, no, I don't even want to make the joke. I don't even want to make the joke, dude. You made, like, you set me up, and I'm like, I can't fucking finish this punch. I can't finish this punchline.
This is the part. This is when we talk about you like this. This is where fucking all the W-know-what dude fans start taking their dicks out and start stroking them. Like, oh, yeah, dead baby. So now we're back. Now we're back, baby.
Now we're talking.
Yeah.
No, but it was one of those things where part of me wanted to prove him wrong and also show compassion for what happened. So I tried to, I was like, I could give a double whammy to this guy.
Yeah.
You know, and you know what? I was like, I did the joke again.
Did you want him to feel guilty for coming at you?
No, well, what I said was, I said, if you listened to the joke,
if
you actually listened to the premise of my joke, you would know that I'm not pro mass shooting and it's my fucking head and it's the shit that I'm thinking about. Mm-hmm. I said, but you heard a buzzword. You heard a buzzword, and as soon as you heard the buzzword because of where you're from, you went. And I said, you got to understand, you're in a comedy venue. And then I said, I'm not an asshole. I said, I'm actually a loving husband and father, and you fucking listened to, and everyone else, no one else had a problem with it. But it made me feel good for two
and then
reasons.
Then he called your wife, and she's like, he's all right sometimes, you know?
Well, coming home at 3 o'clock in the morning. Yeah.
He's like, I checked with your wife. You were smoking sticks with Giannis Pappas till 6 in the morning. Well, you know the roads were bad. I had to wait for the roads.
I had the roads today. I got 2 hours
icy.
In between.
That's a three-stick. That's a three-stick ice cleanup out there.
Hey, when's your first set tonight?
I'm at stand-up. I think I just got one.
What time?
9 something.
Oh, I got a 9:10. We got 2 hours.
We got 2 hours. Stand. Smoke on some stand.
Listen to this. Yeah. Well, hold on. Let me do it. All right. Alexis is no longer smoking sticks because Dee works in a hospital and said that it's like smoking 15 cigarettes.
She works for the premier cancer hospital.
Wait till next time we get together. He'll be smoking one.
What do you mean, an hour?
No. He'll smoke one.
I might be apologizing to her.
Yeah, he'll smoke.
In the next
just
hour.
Lie. Just be like, you know, I was hanging out with Virzi. You know, he smells like cigars all the time.
Yeah, I hug Berg. Yeah. You know? Dude, he put his coat over mine. I'm like, you got to take your coat off of my coat. Yeah. This guy smokes cigars like
what do you mean, Alexis? Yeah. I had three sticks.
This next guy coming to the stage.
Absolutely hilarious.
My favorite thing about him, he's like, yeah, look at this guy, ISIS face. All right, your next comic coming to the stage.
Oh, no, I love
Bert,
you know what I'm talking about, right? Yeah. Black chick who takes cum on the face. All right, next up. We just started the show. How about you? Does your pussy look good? Does it peel it open? Do you send that pic?
Yeah.
You send your pic wide open like it looks like they're about to do surgery on it? Coming to the stage, guys. Your first comedian.
He did this to me in Virzi.
We were at the stage. I go, I love how Berg will just say the most fucking horrific, disgusting thing and then bring you up. And I like clockwork. He's like, yeah, do you like something like black cock? Yeah. He goes, this next guy coming to the stage.
This girl looks like she takes black cock. Coming to the stage, everybody.
To an old lady. He goes, yeah, you're old. Are you going to stay awake? Do you remember the first time you fucked a black guy? Anyway,
coming to the stage. This guy's absolutely hilarious.
Literally did it as we were saying.
He said to an old woman, yeah, an old woman, black cock?
Do you remember the first time you had a black cock? Yeah, you do. All right, your next guy.
You guys like my new baby gators? I got them at Kids Foot Locker. You like them? They're size 6 kids. Now I'm going to go outside and smoke a Churchill at -2.
I've never seen a guy smoke a stick in more hazardous weather. Hazardous fucking weather. Like, Berg's I thought I was bad.
Canadian. That's summer for him. He doesn't.
Yeah, guys. I love Berg.
He's the best.
He's hilarious. Yeah. He's hilarious. The black cock thing kills me. It's so funny.
Took 4 black cocks, didn't you? All right, coming to the stage. You ready, Virzi?
He's like, you old whore. Here's Virzi. He doesn't even, he cuts it out.
He opens the show like that.
He does.
Who's the dirtiest?
His first 10-15 minutes is just like black cock fucking. And then you're up there. You're like, you guys want to hear about my day or no? You've already been desensitized. All right. Yeah. I guess I'll talk about plowing someone's asshole open.
Hey, have this clever observation. No. All right.
No. All right. You guys.
So kids get shot, right? You gotta start with the mass shooting joke when Berg is the host.
Oh, it's like, you know, before I listen to some classical music, I always like to start it with some N.W.A. Niggas Most Wanted.
Yeah. Who's the filthiest comic you've ever seen as far as over the
Jason
top?
Rouse. Even though,
who?
Jason Rouse, by far. Jason Rouse.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, I never seen Jason Rouse.
I don't know him.
I know who he is. I never saw him.
Funny. Good friend. I mean, I've been friends with Jason. You know, I'm fucking...
Dirtiest ever?
Oh, my God. Not even close.
Ever.
Yeah. Ever. Nobody's even close to him.
He makes Berg look like what?
Jason, yeah. Jason is like as dirty as you can go. He's like the filthiest, dirtiest... You know, he used to have a big joke about fucking a retarded girl. That was like his closer. This is how dirty Rouse is. He did Down and Dirty on HBO with Norton. Remember that show?
And Jim Norton's and they edited out?
And he was the only set that didn't make it to air on a Down and Dirty show. On a blue comedy special.
On HBO. Which doesn't matter.
They cut his set because
it was too much?
Because of the fucking retarded girl's joke.
Ugh.
You know? Yeah, he'd go like, you know, she'd wake up the next morning like, what part of Montreal are you from?
Oh my God.
We'll put your visor down on your helmet, sweetheart.
I never saw him. Now that
she'll never leave me. I took the wheels off her chair. I mean, it was it's funny as fuck, but you know.
Jesus.
Oh, he went in, huh?
Oh, yeah, yeah. He goes in all the time. Yeah.
I hope the guy who was mad at your mass shooting joke is listening to that and is just preparing another tweet.
Rouse, like, he has made me laugh the hardest, though. Like, of some, like, when I think back at comedians that I've watched, I remember he took me on tour in Canada. You know, he's big in Canada. He's, you know, and what he used to do is after his set, he'd go get naked in the back and then just come out and start running around the audience, like, with his dick and balls tucked between his legs, being like, I dropped the jawbreaker. You know, like, he'd be bending over, right? And people would be screeching. And just, I was laughing so hard it hurt. Like, yeah, he used to climb over people, get on the tables.
Naked.
Yeah, naked. And then get up on stage and say just like the funny, does anyone know where I can catch the bus? You know, just fucking completely butt naked.
Was he drunk?
No, he was just having fun, you know? He's just wild,
He's
man.
Just having fun. That's just
you just put your dick out and jump on a crowd. I mean,
he did it on. It's fun. I mean, when you're a comic, you know, and you're... You know, comics, we don't laugh at normal shit, you know? It takes so much.
We're broken.
Yeah, I used to have this idea for a sketch that there was like this clown for comedians that we'd all go privately see and like fucking kill puppies and stuff. And the only thing that could make us smile, you know, because we're so dead and jaded inside from watching comedy all the time. So he actually did it on a Swedish TV special and the cops came. Somebody called the cops.
Wait, what did he do? He killed
climbed,
puppies?
No, he didn't kill puppies. No. He He climbed. They started climbing on the audience. He got off stage and started climbing on the audience naked.
Naked. Oh.
And like somebody called the cops in Sweden. Yeah.
Yeah, but you don't want some dude's floppy dick fucking hitting your soul
Canadian shoulder. Canadian. But that's kind of you know that's kind of the fun of it. You know people don't want it.
They don't even know what a jawbreaker is. They're all just scared. Yeah. They never give him a jawbreaker.
Do you want? Did you have some news stuff that we could do?
We could cover. We could go, we can go through some news stories if you want. We can talk about
who's in the chat rooms.
Oh, well, a lot of people want to see Luchana take her top off.
Of course,
I figured, you know, let's not...
Fucking gentlemen in there.
Yeah, a lot of respectful individuals.
One guy did want to say that there are plenty of fans that are not, you know, directly from that ONA group.
Yeah, where are they from?
Yeah, we should have them let us know.
The Mississippi River area?
The alt-right website they advertise on.
But he wants to say we're not all conservative ONA fans.
You're right. I know. I'm
there's
a comedian.
Some nice people.
I use hyperbole.
There's some nice people. As
take it literal.
The first thing you said was everyone wants
let's do the,
to
let's do the,
off.
Let's do the,
nice
we're nice guys, you know, just can you tell the broad to pull out her tits?
Yeah.
But other than that, you know, we're good caring people.
I'm jerking off into a tissue, but look, just like anywhere.
I noticed how when they said that, Alexis was like, well, what do they want?
Yeah. I mean, we should listen to that.
I mean, you know, I'm appreciating what I can see on the webcam as far as the cleavage goes, but if she could pull out some nips, greatly appreciate it. But other than that, we're great guys, you know, we're
her non-comedian boyfriend is in LA going, why?
Yeah.
Why
did she do that? Oh, yeah. This is a podcast where you definitely get into a fight with your boyfriend afterwards.
I thought I was safe. I was going to do a podcast with two married dudes and a guy who was a girlfriend.
Yeah.
Does your boyfriend watch your sets or watch?
Yeah. Well, the first time I met him, we met on Bumble, and then he was coming to my show. He was like, when is your next show? And I was like, tomorrow. He's like, I'm coming. And I was like, okay, whatever. So I ended up having food poisoning that day. It's my show that I produce at the Standing Room called Fuck, Marry, Kill.
Nice plug. Nice plug. Like that. Natural.
It's on Wednesday, February 8th, if anyone wants to come. So he shows, and it was like Jay Farrow was doing it, doing my show, and, you know, it was like oversold out and whatever. And so I was like, I have to go.
Was it really Jay Farrow or was it Denzel?
It was actually...
Denzel and Jay-Z?
It was actually Michael Che, no, Jay is a friend of mine, so I was like, I can't like not show up to my own show if he's doing the show as a favor to me. So I was like throwing up all day. It was awful, but I didn't even think. Right. I like literally peeled myself out of bed, and my co-producer Walker Hayes, she had to start the show. I was like, I'm gonna be late. I have to stop and get like Gatorade and Pedialyte and something,
and
like,
take a few shits as well.
I might have to stop and shit my pants.
Listen, Walker, I'm pissing out of my asshole. Gonna run it a little late.
Yeah. And so I get there and I saw him right away. Like I recognized him, and his arm was in a sling. He just had shoulder surgery. I was like, oh, this is a great match. Like you're crippled.
Sorry, Lucha, I've been jerking off to you too much. Yeah. Boom, falling in love right after that line.
No, so I
hurt my shoulder.
Gonna go up.
Told you I was coming.
Yeah, I was cranking the bird too much to your 5 minute set on YouTube.
I was gonna go up because I was like, I was so sick.
Oh, you went on stage like that?
I did. I ended up closing the show because I started feeling better, and I, you know, I'm kind of dirty, so I was talking about how like I don't sleep with black guys, and also talking about, you know, all these like dirty dick jokes and
I'm
stuff.
I'm not saying that's a good
thing.
So
I get off stage.
It's definitely not a bad thing.
You're well, just saying that because he's in the audience. It's not even one of your
bits.
I just want everyone to know I don't fuck black guys.
What if he was like, oh, thank God. He would say, oh, thank God. Thank God.
That's the only reason he was like, okay with my material, because he's like, oh, he's like, what a whore. But, oh, okay. She's never been with a black guy.
All right.
I can do that.
Wholesome girl.
What is this kid? Italian? What is this kid?
No, he's Irish. White, right. Irish.
Close enough.
Right. So I get off stage and I was like, hey, you know, talking to him. And he's like, this is my mom, Peggy.
Oh, your mom was there.
His mom was there.
And you were like, hi.
And I was like,
that's a fucking, that's a.
Hi.
That's,
she's like, that's you never had a black cock, have you?
Wait a second. Well, hold up.
Oh, you never had that black cock.
Yeah. Hold up one second.
What about a black Irish? Tell you.
This is fucking interesting. So this is the, is this the, he brought his mom?
He brought his mom to meet me for the first time to my comedy show.
He ambushed you with the mom. He didn't tell you the mom was.
No, I didn't even.
And he only met you. And he only met you one time before this.
I never met him. This was the first time we were meeting.
This guy's a murderer.
Wow.
Wait a minute, but wait, I thought you had an interaction with him before. Oh, I know.
You're gonna say that you haven't seen how big he is? He could be fucking big.
He's Irish.
Is he big?
He's Irish. Even if he was tiny,
I'm calling him a real man. That was Alexis Guerrero's that called him a nerd.
I didn't call him a nerd. I said he's a murderer.
Oh, murderer.
A murderer.
Bringing a mom.
Bring mom day one.
I'm not gonna.
That's serious. Yeah.
Well, I mean. it worked because she was like 85% the reason that I even decided to go out with him. Because oh. I didn't really talk to him. I talked to her the whole time.
That
we
is
were, like,
the most
best
Irish
friends.
Thing you could do.
Yeah. We were like best friends.
I really liked your fucking show. I like that part when you're getting fucked by all those guys. It was so great. My son's got a fucking...
Oh, geez.
You can't fuck with her today. She's
I'm trying
got the
to get
shits.
My son laid. She's got the shits.
He never gets laid. He still lives at home. Would you fuck him or something?
Yeah. If you eat her pussy, son, wipe your chin off. She's been shitting.
Can you bring us another couple of beers? I met my son's wife here.
I sold you. I
she's
going to
fuck his brains out.
Yeah. Imagine she was like, why don't you show us your tits up there?
Oh, she's a fucking Mexican girl over here. She's going to fuck Seamus' fucking brains out.
Seamus.
Wait till I call my sister Peggy. We fucking met her.
She's going to fuck Seamus' brains out.
The mom, the priest is there.
He's just there pushing his back into you while you're fucking. Come on, get her! Yeah. You're fucking not doing it hard enough.
Oh my god, dude.
Pretty live
much.
Up to your handle what, name, what, you fucker.
I mean, pretty
what's his
much.
Name?
She was. I'm not gonna say his name.
Oh.
I mean, everybody. Respect, you could just go on Facebook and see what his name is. But, what was I gonna say? No, she was like, she after that was like, that's like the best. The coolest girl you've ever brought around. Like, don't let her go.
Oh, nice.
And I was
that's
like
really
dying
nice.
Of like food poisoning and.
Wow. It's like a Nicholas Sparks movie.
I know, right?
Don't let her go, whatever you do. I won't, Mom.
So you hit it off with the mother that early? That
oh,
quick,
yeah. That,
the first
that day. Like,
that's crazy.
He knows it. I tell him, like, she's 85% the reason I even decided to go on a date with you.
Did she mention anything about your act? Why was she like, I like
well,
that.
When I first...
I like that part where you said
like,
that clean word.
And I was
it's
like,
a bit derivative. I mean, I think
I was
she's
like
criticizing it.
She was like, you're not allowed to hang out with my son. And I was like, she's like, I'm just kidding. You were so funny. And
oh,
like,
nice.
But I also nice. Don't even know what I said because I was so delirious.
Yeah.
I like did like a couple of jokes and then I just made stuff up.
How long did you hang with them after the show that day?
It's so funny because like my friend I had a bunch of friends there and I was like, oh, I gotta go talk to my new family, I'll see you guys later. And so I taught like they were drinking, I was not, and then she was like, can we take you home, like can we give you a ride home? So I was like, yeah. So I'm like sitting in the cab between him and her. And
it's like a
she
weird move.
Did you have to shit the whole time? Was you
no,
we got the
no,
bubbles?
No, it was under control by then. Yeah,
it was under control.
Just, shoved yeah. the tissue in. There.
It's like you just started getting pale and green, trying to listen. Like
that's the worst fucking feeling ever.
That's the worst.
No, but then I remember like sitting in the cab, and she was. I don't even. We were talking about like. Kids or like being a parent or whatever.
Oh,
and she was right. like she was like one day you guys will have kids, like she wasn't saying like us together, but she was just saying like one day you guys will be parents and you'll know, like. And I was thinking, I don't even know if I'm gonna go out with this guy, like what is she, like, what is she
that's
talking
heavy
about?
Early they
that
put
is,
it on you
know,
early
too much
yeah. they
no,
put it on
was,
you early
it was good. I mean no he yeah he came on a little strong after that, but then he thought I didn't, I only agreed. So then they dropped themselves off first and the lady, she was like, can you, you know, take her home. So the lady, his mom. So then he was like, so can I like take you out sometime? And I'm like sitting there between him and his mom. I was like, yeah. He's like, hands me his phone to put my number in there. And I'm just like, I've never given someone my number in front of their mom before. So he thought like, he was thinking like, oh,
you
and his
did
mom,
it because the mom was there.
Yes. But it was not true. And then his mom was like, the next day was St. Patrick's Day, and I was like guest bartending at this bar on the Lower East Side. She's like, we're coming. And he was wow. like, I can't. I just had shoulder surgery. She's like, no, Dad and I are coming. You don't have to come. And then he called me on Friday because I was doing Jay Farrow was headlining Caroline's, and I was on the show. And she wanted to come. He's like, my mom wants to come. Like, she wants to bring. But it was sold out. She couldn't come. But she, yeah, she jeez. Really liked
it. What kind of social life does mother have?
She's, yeah.
she's showing
she's
up to
awesome.
I have a better relationship oh, with this guy's mom than
mom's
I do with my
beast.
Own
mom. Yeah, mom. Yeah. Yeah.
She's the
mom's
best.
Mom's like, I'm dating you now.
She is. She's like.
Lucetta, where you at? I'm hanging out with your mom. We're getting hammered down here on Bleecker.
Yeah.
Your mom's buying yeah. blow off of this, yeah. this guy with a ponytail.
Just did a couple bumps.
Yeah. Take it easy.
No, we like, when she comes into town, we like hang out. out, and she's like, she's so cool. She'll be like, I love bars. I just really do. I love bars. Yeah, she's
that's
awesome.
It's like Greeks with diners. We can't.
Yeah.
When I go, me and Giannis went out for a coffee in a diner, and we just got into peace.
It's
we just
felt peaceful.
You just felt peace. You're just looking around. You smell it. It's like it's in our
drinking
you know,
coffee.
I feel like as a fat guy, I get to be honorary.
Yeah. Alexis is like, I feel like that pizzeria is anything. Yeah. Gyro spots.
Yeah. You got a good burger guy. I
feel warm when I smell meat.
Look, I don't.
That is very true.
I feel warm. I just need to smell meat. I don't trust
from your mom.
Yeah. I don't trust any skinny guy's food recommendations. I just don't. If Deepu told me like it's a great fucking,
I am not skinny. I got some pudge going on.
No, you
get the fuck out of here.
Well, I'm not like y'all. I'm not Alexis.
All right, whoa.
Alexis tells me there's good food somewhere. You know it's good.
Because
Giannis was a tough nut to crack though. With me talking about food, Giannis like I'm not so sure.
Really?
Like a year later, Giannis like, all right, now I respect.
Have you seen?
Well, we had a disagreement over
pictures of food.
Yeah,
I'm like, I want all of that. Where is it? He's like, oh, it's in fucking.
You love pizza too.
I love.
You constantly post
as you. On my pizza tour.
You put a lot of fucking red pepper flakes on your pizza.
I know, I'm crazy.
She drowns it.
She's from fucking Chile, dude.
I unscrew the thing.
I thought she was
and
Mexican.
I sprinkle it like that.
She's Chilean.
Mexican. Oh, look at me, fucking
so racist.
Jesus Christ.
Ah, Chile, Mexican. Yeah.
Oh, it's LA.
No, just kidding.
Also, just Chileans don't really eat that much spicy food. It's, you know, just because of the word.
Yeah. Oh. Actually, Cubans don't eat that much spicy food.
No, not at all.
I ate Cuban food in Miami. And I was like, can I have some hot sauce? They're like, yeah. They hand me Tabasco. I was like, fuck this place.
Yeah, that's
where am
water.
I? Like,
yeah.
How
although,
dare you? Like,
although,
I'm looking for some like in-house, like back of the kitchen. Like,
no. Yeah. You got it. If you go to like a real Havana spot, they got habanero pepper sauce, which is incredible.
I love that when Spanish people do
that.
Habanero.
No, that's
they got some habanero.
That's what Italians do, though. We go to the mozzarella.
Oh, oh,
you gotta try that.
Gotta get the mozzarella
with the goat.
Also, they're not saying any of it right.
Yeah. When people, they're like mozzarella, I'm like, you're not, and I get it, but I don't go and be like, hey, can I have a burrito with black beans and chicken?
A lot of Latin people do though.
But
they do that.
Yeah, when they don't speak the English language properly, you know. With
my wife
actually,
first time I met her when we started dating, we went to a deli. I went to get a
sandwich.
On
the beach in Miami.
And she goes, I washed for sure. it's mozzarella. And I go, no, there's a fucking A at the end. It's mozzarella. And I said, I was like, mozzarella. I said it the way you say it. She's like, no, it's mozzarella. Dude, a year later, she's cheating off of me in Italian class in college. And I'm like, why the fuck would you ever yell at me in the deli?
Yeah.
You don't even know how to speak your own language.
Yeah.
I ask her uncle, they say gabagool. I go, spell gabagool for me. They're like, G-A. I'm like, you idiot, it's capicola. I was like, you don't even know what the fuck you're saying.
They just watched an episode of The Sopranos.
They soak it in and they become that. Her uncles are actually pretty
cool. Like Big Pussy called it gabagool.
Yeah.
You know?
You want to, let's do some of those stories.
All right, sure.
I want to talk about this story here. This is an interesting one.
You know what? I just want to say quickly about the Italians. You mind if I say this? Italians fucking hate being stereotyped as like mobsters and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Well, how about every time I walk into an Italian restaurant, you don't got the fucking cast of every mob movie up there.
If
you hate being stereotyped so much, how come you got fucking Christopher from The Sopranos with every waiter in the joint?
Yeah. I have. It's a good picture. You know, we support our actors.
Yeah, but you guys, there's so many mob movie fucking photos in the place. And they're like, they don't stereotype us. It's like, how about you guys calm down with the
fucking... How you doing, Hendry?
How you doing, Hendry?
That's my favorite.
I'm fucking trying to make this party, Hendry. I do a lot of fucking favors for you.
He goes, Jew bro. Prejudice against Italians. Believe that in this day and age? Fucking prejudice against Italians? What do we got? Boy Scouts. Let's do this one.
Yeah, so that was a big story that came out yesterday. Boy Scouts will now allow transgender children to join the organization. Any child that identifies as a boy.
So yeah, if you fill out the application with the gender male, you're in.
For Boy Scouts of America.
Boy Scouts.
Yeah.
Even if they haven't had like reassignment surgery?
Yes, even pre-op.
If you identify.
Identify.
Wait, what's reassignment surgery?
That's when they swap pieces downstairs.
Or if they just start taking hormone therapy.
Pieces.
Wait a minute, though. What do you mean they replace? Oh, it's not a fucking car.
No, they do.
they replace them. You know, they take out the...
They legitimately
They take out the undercarriage.
What they do, they actually turn your dick inside out.
They turn your dick inside out and turn it into a puss.
Oh,
so you could still... I'm not kidding.
No,
so you still get... If you get pounded
out,
it's like jerking off.
Wait,
do the other way around?
They don't do anything.
Wait a minute, what do you mean?
Take testosterone, your clit grows out a little bit.
So, what?
Yeah.
So wait a minute, they take the dick and they fold it in?
Not all transgendered people do that. A lot of them are called pre-op. So what they do is they just take hormones. And if you've been taking hormones,
why do you know so much about this?
Because I had to play a character that's that, and so I know everything about him.
Oh, Marisa.
That's right. That's right.
Well,
that's
what did Marisa right, do? Right. Did Marisa? Right.
Marisa's pre-op. She still got the dick. She loves dick. She likes to get into sword fights. That's it. That's it. Yeah. I'm not trying to have no calamari. Not even on me. I'm not attracted to that shit.
So you learned everything about it.
I know everything about it.
Oh. You learned everything about it because of the cat, which is a very responsible thing.
That's a very
responsible thing. You know,
I'm sure. Do you know anything about the island of Puerto Rico? Did you study that?
I know
part?
That it's fucking crowded.
Yeah.
Yeah. The old showrunner of my show, Infusion, was from Puerto Rico. He said just fucking crowded.
A lot of people. Yeah. No one's in the mountains. That's
So do Boy Scouts like have to change in front of each other? What's the issue with it? I don't like what.
They used to do that back when I was a Boy Scout.
I love. I just want you to tell Virzi all this. I love watching an Italian from Yonkers struggle with this. I'm a little confused. Wait a second.
No, he goes.
So hold up a second here. Let me get this fucking straight.
They turn your dick inside out.
So the kid is born a boy, and anyone should be called. What the fuck's the world coming to? It doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
It's like calling a salami sandwich a slice of pizza. It's just not.
How funny is it that Italians say I'm a little confused?
I'm a little confused.
And when Italians don't know or understand, I'm a little. My dad does that.
It's Columbo.
Yeah.
I got one more question.
No, they're just trying to politely say get the fuck out of here with that shit.
It's a polite. Like my dad will say, I saw something on TV. I'm a little confused. I'm just like, no, you didn't like what the fuck you saw.
Yeah. I was watching his TV show, and then the white actor, he was kissing a black actor. I'm just a little confused. It's kind of sending the wrong message. No,
I mean, I'm just saying, we need to stick together.
I'm just saying it's not a bad thing.
I wasn't raised that way.
That's all I'm saying.
That's all I'm saying. What's the problem?
So what happened was,
I'm not saying they can't stay in their own neighborhoods. I mean, that's fine, you know?
I'm just saying, don't cross
I'm just
over
saying,
the line.
Don't come across the big deal, you know?
You don't got stores
I mean, why would they want to come over here anyway, you know? I mean, we're going to hit them with a bat, so why would you want to come over here? I don't understand.
So the kid's mom actually sent him to the Boy Scouts and didn't tell anybody that the kid had female genitalia, and she got a call one day from the Boy Scouts, and they just said, hey, listen, I guess there was an incident which no one ever talked about, no one ever explained, but somehow they found out that she had female genitalia, which is another weird part of it.
Right, when the camp counselor tried to rape her, and I don't like these parts. Where's the little dick? Yeah. That's what I'm in it for.
Take the kid in the woods for a little fun.
Right? The fuck happened over there? 20 hours a week. He sends a little dick.
Sends it
you
back.
Coming in here with pussy?
Sends it back like an undercooked steak. There's something wrong with this one. This boy's no good. This boy's no good.
Trying to rape this one. Says it's a boy. Lied to me.
How am I supposed to jerk it off?
Yeah. I can't suck a dick if there is no.
You know, molesting's not like it used to be.
Not like it used to be.
I'm a little confused
here.
I'm a little confused. Usually the dick comes out. You know,
this is the tiniest dick I ever seen.
So
there was a lawsuit after that incident because they tried to take the kid out. She sued the Boy Scouts, and she has won. Everyone's kind of just every organization is addressing their political views through these small actions.
Right.
Nowadays, like now we have a Starbucks. You know, they said they're going to hire 10,000 refugees, and now people are boycotting Starbucks because people don't want to support that point of view. So it's an interesting time.
So every micro, okay, I get it. So it's little things, little cases these that little, represent.
Everything's becoming politicized.
Got you. Well, the thing about the kid with the in the Boy Scouts, is it was, I don't understand. If it feels like a boy, it acts like a boy, it's a boy. Is that, you know? I mean,
well, it doesn't feel like a boy in this case. Well, no, I mean,
Let's no, it does feel like a boy.
The only camp counselor, what's it feel like?
Like, look, the kid was born as a boy, you know? Like, the kid's born as a boy.
Born as a girl.
No,
it's born as a girl.
Okay. Yeah. So she feels like she's a boy, you know? Her brain is different. You know, Danish scientists have done studies on this. The brains are different. They light up different. You know, more empathy, more kind of a female brain. Mm-hmm. The kid feels like she's a boy. The only thing that makes us boys and what makes us girls is just fucking either testosterone or estrogen, which we both have in us.
Right.
So there's some girls, you know how they're like a little masculine? Is a higher testosterone. How about that chick from Connecticut? Or Brittany, the chick in the WNBA, he's got a fucking Adam's apple.
Yeah, Brittany Griner.
You know, she's a girl.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's just these people who have a hard time with the blurring of lines.
No,
it's not your fucking business.
No, that girl, no, Brittany, is like a boy.
Girl's not going to do anything to your kid, all right? If this happens in, like, let's say Park Slope, Brooklyn or something, nobody has a fucking problem with it. Yeah. Just because everyone's accepting. It's just these areas where people aren't used to something.
Right.
So they fucking, oh, what the fuck is it? The kid's just fucking a kid.
I love how Giannis prefaced it with like, yeah, this Danish scientist.
It's Danish.
he always knows. Like a
Scandinavian. Yeah.
They've done autopsies on transgendered people's brains to see them differently. They've also done CAT scans. You know, they know everything about how your brain lights up. I mean, that's how they know when certain people are psychopaths, you know, they have a serial killer, they look at the brain.
It's different qualities
that light up, and the transgender brains are 100% of the time different than straight male. I'm talking about, you know, male to woman pre-op or post-op transgender. It's always different from male, you know? I'm sure if you look at a gay guy's brain, it's different than, you know?
But what if this...
He's dreaming about cock all the time, you know? Lights up, cock, 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 cock.
Oh my god, that's gotta be, you guys gotta have that on a fucking
drop.
Yeah. That's gotta be a drop.
That's the name of the episode. Cock, 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 cock.
You know what, dude?
People say it's unnatural. It's like, well, then fixing someone's heart's unnatural. Well, then, you know, giving someone cancer surgery is unnatural. The list could go on and on and on. There's no such thing as unnatural. Everything is in nature.
There's no such thing as natural.
There's no such thing as unnatural.
All of it is
everything
natural.
Is in nature.
Right.
Okay? If you're given the if you start taking estrogen, you grow tits. You become a chick. You just don't have a puss. But you still can be hot with a dick. And people might jerk off to it.
If this girl, though, is hanging out with these boys, and they're, like, starting to come into puberty, and they just start talking about that shit. I mean, that seems like that would be a...
But she already don't think and act like a girl. So for her, she'd be like, yeah, jerking off.
I think it's more of an issue for her because, you know, I mean, I don't want to think that the Boy Scouts are going to bully their fellow boy Girl Scout, but you never know. You know what I mean? Like, because people like to bully someone that's different. So that's...
Yeah, but that's going to happen anyway.
How old?
I know, but I'm just saying, like, that's... She wants to go through that. I don't know.
I just don't like the hypocrisy. You know, it's like,
yeah,
it's like, is this America or is it not?
Right.
Or is it your, what does freedom mean to you?
Right.
So it means you can do the things that you want, right? As long as they don't hurt anybody else, but other people can't do what they want. Because it's making you uncomfortable or something.
Right.
Go, if you don't like it, fine. I'm not saying you can't like it, but you know, you can't fucking try to hurt somebody or protest the place or call it immoral. Who the fuck are you?
Right.
Maybe you're immoral. I mean, you know, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Everyone, go to another one then. You can not like it if you don't want, but you can't infringe or encroach on somebody else's freedoms or what they want to do. That's what America's about. I just hate that hypocrisy. Like, we're for freedom. Except, no, this, that, the other thing. Here's a list of 1,000 things that we're against.
It's
fucking freedom, dude.
I would feel it would be hard for the girl. I would feel like for the girl to want to be in that would be really fucking weird and hard.
Who the fuck are we to stop a girl from doing something she wants to do?
Or
a
boy, because she wants to be a boy.
No, that's brave.
Just to protect her. It's like, dude, when I was a kid, like, you know, there were bullies, there were gang members. My mother wasn't like, don't walk the street. You know what I mean? It's like, you gotta be able to survive in this world. So go learn. If this kid wants to be a Boy Scout and she feels she's a boy, look, it ain't going to be easy for you, kid. Get out there and fucking learn how to make a fire.
Yeah.
Okay?
The universe doesn't give a fuck.
No.
Doesn't give a fuck. Everyone needs to calm the fuck down. All right? You're a fungus growing on a rock, floating in nothingness.
See, the problem is the people that believe they're going to be judged for it when they die.
Well,
that's
get rid of that 7th century fucking 7th century nonsense.
I agree.
You know, those are the same people who hate Muslims for believing all that dumb shit.
Yeah.
So you believe dumb shit too. Now, the issue is there is an issue.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Because it's both sides, yeah.
Ah, it's just you believe it in 7th century shit.
It's like a guy in a church laughing at Scientology.
You believe that the fucking...
What are you doing?
You think there was Adam and Eve and a woman was made of a rib out of a man, and you think the world is... You know, there's no dinosaurs. You're like, hey, it just started. There was just humans.
I think it's different
with Scientology. We're fucking apes.
Okay. I think it's different with Scientology, though. I do think it is. Here's how I think it's different.
How?
Because at least with a god, right? And it's just my opinion, but at least with a god, it's something mythical that we don't know and that we can't see.
Right.
Okay, L. Ron Hubbard wrote a fucking comic book.
Right.
You know, like at least there's
it's not different, dude. He believes in aliens. I bet you there's a huger chance we'll know that there's aliens someday than there is a god.
Yeah, and also, he wrote a book. We know who wrote it. Who wrote the Bible? It's a collection of stories people used to tell to each other. They never...
Nobody wrote anything down for 300 years.
Have you guys seen this thing that Leah Remini's doing? What this chick is doing on... Yeah. Have you watched what they do?
I'm very proud of her. Yeah,
but I want to say this.
It's amazing what she's doing.
To come out of this and do what she's doing.
I want to say this about the transgender people. There is the issue, and I understand this issue, and it's a parent struggle with it. It's like... at what age do you determine that this kid knows
right.
that he what he wants, what he or she wants to do? You know, because a lot of these kids do regret it. That does happen.
Wait, what do you mean? What do you mean?
Like if you're a 7-year-old kid,
right,
and you're like, I feel like I'm a boy. I want to be a boy. I identify as a boy. That's just how I'm built.
She's a girl, but
wants to be a boy. I'm transgendered, you know. And you're a parent. You're going like, am I gonna let this kid? Because this stuff is irreversible. You know, it's irreversible. You start taking hormones and stuff like that. It's irreversible. It does things to your body that are irreversible. So this is such a huge decision of such unbelievable magnitude. To let a 7-year-old decide. Because what does happen, a lot of these kids do it and then they end up regretting it and they say, you know, I wish I would have waited a little bit because my feelings changed.
Did you see the thing of Ruby Rose from Orange is the New Black?
No.
She said that she felt like she was a boy, but she never had the surgery, and she's glad because now she's like, I want to have kids. Like, I'm so glad I never.
No,
that'd
be tough to like slap on tits and then not want them. And like,
and it happened. And that does happen.
Yeah,
and then not want them.
You could do that with pizza.
I feel like if a guy got a set of tits in any way, he'd probably be like, oh, that's
yeah,
okay.
I mean, cutting your dick. But you can't make any sexual moves like that until you're 18, anyway, right?
No. No, that's not, it depends. No, you can do it.
If your parents are demanding it.
Yeah, there's a girl who has a reality show. A young girl. I forgot the name, but she has like a reality show about her transition.
I think Frontline or 60 Minutes or I can't really remember where.
Dude, that's almost criminal. You can't give a 7-year-old fucking shit.
Well, that's
crazy.
Where the issue
dude, my
comes
mother
in.
Didn't let me pick a menu item at a restaurant at 7.
Yeah, you can't be. Yeah. Yeah. Be like, I don't want a dick. Yeah. All right, we'll go to the doctor on Monday. We'll take care of this.
But I'll tell you what you eat for dinner.
But you are having mac and cheese.
Yeah, you're eating all that chicken.
All your vegetables.
And then,
before you
then
get
if
out.
You eat all that chicken, we'll take your dick off.
Yeah.
But not until you eat all.
I think they should wait. I think they should wait. Obviously. But then on the flip side, if they start early, then you really, that's the, but then on the flip side, I understand, because if you really want to be a girl, you start early, before, because they do testosterone suppression, so you basically become a girl. I mean, you could not tell, the earlier you start, nobody in this room would be able to tell, because it's basically a girl. There's a real tits, there's a real feminine figure, high voice, you know, she's a girl, except she's a girl. Everything about her is a girl except
like hands, feet, and like Adam's apple.
No, not necessarily, because if you're taking the estrogen from that early, your body
really
develop. You don't develop as a man. You develop as a girl. Because that's the only thing. That's the only thing that makes us girl or boy is those two chemicals, testosterone or estrogen.
Have you gotten a handy from a tranny, transsexual?
No, but I would. Yeah, she's hot.
You said something that I still think. I still quote.
Yeah,
that if you got tricked. Do you remember this?
What would I say?
If you got tricked by a girl, if you were fucking someone from
I wouldn't stop it. If I was attracted
you said,
to
would
the
you
person.
You'd reach around and feel a dick. What, do you remember
oh, yeah,
what
that's
said?
A good joke, actually.
It was fucking great. Do you remember what you said?
Yeah, I said I'd reach around and just pretend like I popped through to the other side.
It was his own dick. Like it was his own dick. He was so big, he went through and he's like, I just pretend I'm fucking.
Yeah.
Dude, that is.
That's funny.
That burned itself in my brain. I'm like, that is still
I wish no big deal. Just pretend like I popped through to the other side. It actually felt like my dick's that big that it came out the other side. Look, I'm a straight man. I love women too much. It's, you know, I just like, I'm like very heterosexual. I would, you know, everyone's kind of on a scale.
Yeah.
I'm like tortured by like how beautiful women are. Like, it's just like always a thought in my mind. Like, I just, like if I was a Roman emperor, it would just be bad. It would now just
Caligula.
Be bad. Yeah, I'd just be like, it would be bad. Yeah. And,
What the
I just bad. And,
like
you know,
Saddam Hussein's kids.
Yeah,
like
it's
that.
Like if I'm attracted to you because you have all. I'm attracted to femininity. So if you embody femininity, like just like a girl, and I can't see what's in your fucking under your dress or your pants or whatever, I'm gonna be attracted. If I see a dick, am I gonna go, whoa, I'm just gonna, all right, well, I guess we're doing something different tonight, you know?
Yeah, but I feel like
I look at my own dick all the time.
I don't know, dude. If I got a sandwich, I'm like, oh, this is tofu, I wouldn't eat it. You know what I mean? Like,
no, but I've looked at my dick, right? And I've admired my dick. You know, sometimes I look at my dick, not a lot.
Because you got a big dick.
But
you
like,
said you
yeah,
got a big
dick. No, but if I sell my dick, right? Again, I'm going in the
shower.
How
hilarious would it be fucking seeing Virzi naked with a big dick?
Just dragging it.
Just 5'8", walking around.
Yeah, yeah.
A little gut hanging out, just big fucking mule off to the right.
We keep moving our seats back.
Off to the right.
We keep shifting back.
Yeah, but I feel like if you see that dick, if your own dick, it's different. If you're messing around and you think it's a woman and a dick popped out, you know.
A limp dick's ugly, but a hard one is
I do a bit on a limp dick is the ugliest thing ever.
It's the ugliest fucking thing. But I'm saying if you... hard dick's kind of like...
It's a little aggressive, a hard dick. Like, I don't think I want to see a hard
dick. You know, here's the deal.
You don't want it?
I don't want a hard dick near me, no.
You've never double-teamed a girl?
You'd rather have a soft dick?
I wouldn't want any dick if I had to.
Well, right, but
a soft dick tells me, this guy's not ready for action. I think I'm a little safer. Yeah. A hard dick is like, anything can happen.
Touche. Yeah. That makes sense.
To me, it's just a sex
But if you were making out with a girl that you thought was attractive and you were trying to hook up with it, and then she got you felt on her pants and you were thinking you're going to rub, you know, you're going to rub her, you know.
Yeah, pussy. You could say it. We're on a podcast.
Yeah. But
And it was a dick. Yeah, I'd be like, yeah, I'm sorry, but the night ends right now.
I'm saying the hard-on's got to go down at that.
Yeah. No. You got at least can you get soft again?
You think in theory it would, but you know, communism also is a great theory.
Your hard on.
Doesn't work in reality.
My erection.
No, yeah. I mean his hard on.
Yes, his. If
this just got really fucking weird.
Yeah, no, no.
No, his dick. Everybody just went like this.
My dick.
It's almost like a standoff with
guns. Here's the deal. Here's the fact.
I know whose dick.
Here's the data.
I'm not saying like get away from me, I'm not gay. I'm just like this isn't what I signed up for.
That's fine, and that's fine. Hey, I mean, if that's the way you react, that's fine.
All respect to you.
I don't know if I believe it 100% for the people who say it generally. I think people are scared of it and they say fucking. I think if they were in that situation with a hot ass fucking transgender girl.
Yeah, but then
that takes away the hot. That takes away the hot.
That's fine. Yeah. That could be fine. But here's the reality. Here's the reality. Transgendered porn is like the third most watched porn.
That's because people don't know what else kind of porn to watch.
I also think
really.
I also think it's that guy you were talking about who doesn't know.
I've never watched it once.
Really? Like, well, I guess I'm going to see the whole thing right here.
It's the third most watched porn, so there's a lot of guys, and they're all straight guys.
They're all
straight guys that identify. You ask a gay guy if he likes a transgendered person. 100% of them go.
But it makes sense that it's third. Yeah. It makes sense that it's third because you have hetero, then you have gay.
Well,
you got
lesbian. Oh, you got a lot of
but
categories.
Also,
you got like lesbian.
Transgender probably appeals to other people, like maybe gay people.
Nope,
or,
it doesn't.
Know.
But it does not.
Really?
Yep, it does not. You see, we're learning today.
With the facts. You got all the transgender facts.
Ask a gay guy.
You're saying that it's attractive to straight males.
It's only attractive to straight males. Yeah, or maybe
bi. How can prove that? How can they prove that?
Ask them. Just ask them.
How can you prove that only straight men are going to training?
Because that's...
Is there anyone on the message board?
You know how many straight guys or how many guys I know that my gay male friends have hooked up with who are straight guys?
Well, that's gay to me. I don't ever want to hook up with a guy like a fucking straight hairy leg.
No,
a guy with fake tits. Now we're talking.
That's what I'm saying,
but that's ignorant. That's ignorant to call him a guy with fake tits.
But that's what I'm saying.
Ignorant.
They can't prove that it's only straight guys that are interested in this because I know straight guys that have hooked up with my gay guy friends.
Right. If they consider themselves straight, I guess.
Wait a minute. So you know what I mean? But then they're not straight then.
Exactly.
That to me is a little weird. But according to Thomas Dale, then they're straight. That's the only guys he's attracted to, straight guys, and they do that. They have a kink on the side.
Yeah,
or
but that means they're not 100% heterosexual.
Well, that's right. I mean, is anyone 100% heterosexual? Then how did ancient Greece happen? What happens in jail? Is everyone 100% heterosexual? Well,
I mean, I think
you know.
Also, do you have to say ancient Greece? I think we all know.
You know,
I mean,
it's not just Greece.
Yeah, no,
happened in the Ottoman Empire, the Roman Empire.
Happens in every empire.
Happens everywhere.
Look, you know,
everyone 100%? I mean, I think it's a scale. I think that's the most...
No, because I can look at a man and go, that's an attractive guy, but I don't want any part of it. But I remember, you know, I'll give you an example. I remember I was in the mall once, right? I was in the mall around Christmas time years ago, and I never forget. I just saw this girl's figure, and it was I'm not even joking. I was like 18, 19, and this girl's figure was like, I couldn't believe it was everything. The curve and the ass was coming out of the yoga pants, and my dick just jolted. No, my dick jolted. My dick just pulsated.
It
like
woke
it just,
up.
It just, it instinctively. I didn't try. I didn't do anything. My dick just was like, whoa, you know. And then if I see a good-looking man, that's like, oh, that guy must get girls. That guy must crush it. Yeah. My dick won't do. Like it's just, I'm not. So,
now, what if that girl was transgendered?
Well, my dick would. See her dick and go no.
I'm saying if you saw her in the mall.
Oh, then that's different. Yeah, that's different. We didn't say that. I'm saying you could be kissing. You could be hot and heavy and into it. But I'm saying once you feel a hard on that's
that
not yours,
not,
and it's it. That's a game chick because then there's a pair of balls, and then the whole thing gets into your head.
Boner killer.
So you were. So let me get this straight. So you were attracted. So when you were attracted to everything about her, everything, just fucking hottish, made your dick jolt or whatever, until you see the dick.
Yes, he's not looking for a dick. He's looking for a vagina.
A dick is a deal breaker.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it is.
It's not. If it's not to you, that's fine. I'm not sure if I
believe you 100%.
All right. I mean, there's only one way to prove it. Who, show me your
dick.
Let's
get one in here.
Yeah,
let's get Bailey J in here. See what happens.
I've been around her. I've met her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Remember,
and it, was she hot
and didn't, you know.
She's a very effeminate looking person.
Yeah. Very nice, very you know, but it's just like it didn't, you know, you see the
And I remember she said she has a boyfriend or a
husband. Well, you two guys maybe, you know, that may be the way it is, but I tell you what.
Look,
guys are watching it. It's the third most watched porn.
Good for them.
You could say you don't know who's watching it, but just ask. Ask gay guys if they watch it.
I wish they
gay guys don't watch it.
I'm not saying gay guys. I'm saying the same straight guys that are hooking up with gay dudes.
I don't know if that's the
and
dominant.
Have girlfriends. I've met these guys. They have girlfriends.
Straight men that watch transsexual porn are not 100% straight. Why would you? Because why would you? Because that means that you want to see penises all over the fucking joint.
I think that
you want to see penises. You want to see both.
Wait a second. Do you guys watch? You guys watch porn? You watch straight porn?
I'm a little confused.
I don't really watch porn.
You watch straight porn?
I mean, I don't watch it as much anymore, but that's the porn
There's
I watch.
A lot of hard dicks in that, too. You're watching another guy.
I watch, what's it called? That's Chappelle's joke.
Girl.
Chappelle said he's got to have more, there's got to be more girls or equal amount
of dicks.
Yeah.
I mean, there's hard dicks in there. It's a phallic symbol. It's
I actually think
about
that.
The mind. Porn, when you're watching
it does.
Porn.
They put you guys in a study. That's the way we'd really know. They'd put you in a study. They've done this. This is how they know who watches it and who doesn't. This is how they know. They do studies.
You're just
rejecting all data then.
That seems to be
the culture in America now.
No one's rejecting any data.
I could unequivocally tell you I've never watched
it.
My children
will
have never watched
it. They'll hook you up, you know? They hook you up to fucking sensors and they hook you, your penis up
to see. Yeah, they
put
the thing around your
They do that. And your brain. They do everything.
Yeah.
And then they show you the different types of porn.
It's just a dick. I'm like,
they show you the different types of porn and they see what happens. And you know, a lot of the studies that they've done, a lot of the guys who are like, fuck that, I would never do that. The guys who are like, I don't like gay porn.
Why do they have those to be Italian accent? Yeah, fuck that shit. Get the fuck out. I'm a little confused.
The guys who are like very open-minded.
I'm very confused right now.
They find the guys that are like very open-minded kind of just like say, you know,
one day I was at my mom's house. She made
they're
some
always
lasagna.
A lot straighter.
I watched some porn.
Than what they like than the guys who are like, once this is dick, I'm out. I don't like gay. And then they show them gay porn. And then we always want what, you know.
But that's it's like the guys who are like the, you know, the congressmen from the South that are like so anti. Yeah.
So what are you,
they're the
are
ones
you actually,
trolling for dick.
So what are you saying? Are you saying
I'm
that
saying
a straight
sexual, No, I'm saying sexuality is a scale. I'm saying it's a scale.
Don't disagree.
It's like a scale, right? So you can be like
90%
90%,
straight.
8, 9, you know, you're on a scale. I mean, you know, it's like we do it for reproduction, but it really feels good. You can't help the things that attract you.
Exactly.
And it's a scale. And I'm also saying transgendered porn, the people who are attracted to third sex people, you can ask transgendered people and you can also ask gay people. And ask any of them. Not it's not going to be the exception. Gay guys, every gay guy will tell you that that does not turn them on.
Right.
So who's watching it? That's my point. Who is watching the third most watched
closeted
search?
I think closeted homosexuals.
So then that means that how many homosexuals there are? No, they're not.
Or if they can't explore that in their real life, they're doing it. They're watching so much more porn.
Exactly.
Per capita, which is why.
Yeah. Well,
it's
that's
so
what
popular.
They say. They say when you've watched enough
that's
porn.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah,
you know
what's
actually
like people like. Different, you know,
you go
like
down a rabbit
stuff.
Hole
it's
after
like,
I think you've seen everything
literally.
That you want to
you guys
see.
Are just looking for it's hilarious because you guys are looking for
no,
rationalization.
I'm giving you actual information.
No, you're not giving me anything that
we are, and
that,
we've actually
no,
agreed with
no,
you.
No, you're
you
giving
refuse to
none
accept.
Of you are giving me any
what's
data.
The answer you
what's
want?
Your data? You're just saying the reason is I know the reason.
No,
the reason is
other
I'm telling you the data. I'm telling
you. We've literally agreed with you every step of the way, and you will not accept it.
What's your data? What study have you? What study have you read?
None.
That says that these guys are closeted homosexuals.
We've agreed with you.
No, you just said they're closeted homosexuals.
Option. That's an option.
So I want to know what study you read. Where that says that the people who are watching
honest, this doesn't
I'm
take up a lot of my time.
That,
well, then there you
I'm
go.
Not
and
also, that that's the fact. I'm saying I know straight guys who have hooked up with my gay guy friends.
Are they watching transgendered porn?
Probably.
Can we
ask
them?
Oh, probably is not. Is not going to cut it.
Giannis, do you think that person is straight? Hold on. Do you think that person is straight? Someone who is in a relationship, in a heterosexual relationship,
and getting,
but
and blowing
hooks up with
gay, a gay guy or getting
blowing a gay guy. That's
I
the next
think
level.
That
is that
person?
Person
knows in himself. What he's really into, and that could be a kink on the side that he likes. Yes.
But you don't think
it's
that
up to him.
You don't think that kink slides him down that scale closer
it
to
it slides
gay.
Him down the scale
closer
but
to
if
gay.
He identifies as heterosexual
I don't think it's
then
a,
he's
I'll tell you this, I don't think it's the third most watched. Deepu, look that up. I actually did look it up
and I have the 25 most searched terms
data.
On Pornhub.
Go for
are we
it.
Going with, are we co- can we use that? All right.
Deplorable. I'm giving you all these names for Alex.
Okay. Oh, I was thinking Into Deepu. What do you think?
No, terrible.
Okay, anyway.
It's not
so,
a 90s like R&B album. So.
That's true.
Okay,
God, I hope
so
I'm right here.
The top, starting at number, I guess we go from number one.
Yeah.
The most searched term on Pornhub this past year was stepmom.
Sounds about right.
How funny is this? Wait up. Bobby just texted me. he texted me. Don't look at your fucking phone when you're doing the show. And I'm just looking at my phone to see that text.
Yeah, he's in the chat room right now. But the second most...
Hey, Bobby.
Yep. Why isn't he here?
Bobby!
I think he's on the road or something. But
I don't think I don't think it's the third most watched.
Let's see. Stepmom.
Hold on, we'll get to it. Good. Stepmom.
Number two is cartoon.
Wow.
This is the third most watched. This is third most Google search within
Pornhub.
These are
like terms, yeah.
Top U.S. searches of 2015. So only U.S.
2015? Yeah, but it's 2017. Where are those?
That is true.
Yeah, no more data. I'm scared I'm going to be wrong, so let's just get out.
Say the third. Say the third.
No, look, lesbian is third.
Uh-huh. Third, lesbian.
Makes sense. Yeah.
Fourth is teen.
Uh-huh. Fifth is black.
Hilarious.
Sixth
is MILF.
MILF.
How far do we have to go?
See,
to get
how far to
transgender?
Transgender is not on this list.
Oh, yeah.
That's
not
2 years ago.
That was
there's
my
been a lot
my
of
first thought after that was that's a wrong stat. That's a wrong stat.
No. There's Google most watched porn.
Linda, wrong stat.
Go Google most.
Come on, there's rough. There's Dominique.
They did. I'll send you a TED talk by these two scientists who did it.
Oh, now I'm on porn.
God, like, no, these two Danish scientists, yeah. I swear.
There's a study in Fiji.
I'll send Deepu all the articles.
Go
you post them up.
Go to imalittleconfused.com.
I hope that's the name of this.
Do you know? You know what it is? Giannis said it so confidently.
We all believe it.
Fucking hook.
Because it's true. It is true.
When did you get this information?
I've been reading. I read all about it. I'll send all the links.
Dude,
I don't have them on me right now because I'm sitting
reading.
Here.
There's two scientists in Lebanon. They said that people eat rice after 10 p.m. The third most.
Third most
times you eat rice after 10. Not before.
Here we go. I'm going to fucking Google it.
Make up 35% of the food you're eating.
Dude, you like soup? They say if
Giannis, get off your phone. Bobby won't.
There's four
won't
scientists
like that.
Who never graduated college. I still respect them. Who say
if you eat liver, you like dick more than the next guy? Yeah. I swear to God, this Chilean.
There's a Russian blog. You got to translate it on Google, so I might be a little wrong.
Yeah, I'm not sure if I can find 2016 stats, but. Just nothing's coming
out. I love how stepmom is one.
And then MILF is like number five.
It's gotta be, though.
MILF is like number five.
There's a lady in your house who's kind of hot, but you can't.
Yeah, but she's blowing your dad. It's like.
Why is cartoon number two? Like, that's.
That bothers you?
Yeah.
That seems pretty safe, actually. I'm
happy
with that.
But people.
Like, it's actual cartoons having sex? I've never seen.
I bet you pissing. I would guess pissing is more than transsexual.
Especially now after.
No way. No way.
There's a lot of people that like that pissing, man.
Are they straight? Is that straight?
What, pissing?
Getting pissed on?
Yeah. Just a little dirty.
Yeah, you just didn't get hugged
I think it's I think it's actually like kind of like a self-deprecation. It's a really, to get pissed on or shit on means you really don't think highly of yourself.
I had a friend who's
you know?
Whose girl.
You can't be like, shit on my chest.
Yeah.
I love myself.
I'm a beautiful person. Yeah, no, put the cellophane foil around my face.
Listen, punch me in the nose while you're shitting on my chest. That's just, I'm into it.
No, I had a great relationship with my dad. Why do you ask?
All right, here we go. Here we go.
What is the message board saying while he's pulling this up?
There's a Sydney Morning Herald, Australia.
All
right.
The headline is, "Our Sexual Desires Exposed by Neuroscientist Porn Study." So these are neuroscientists doing the study.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Straight men are aroused by penises as homosexuals. The study also gathered some revealing insights into women's porn searches. The study, which dubbed the world's
women's porn searches like Clean House.
20 sexual interests that account 20 sexual interests that accounted for 80% of all the porn people watch and spent money on them. The top five categories are youth, gays, MILFs, breasts, cheating wives, four body parts, straight men. Where
are we just listening to you?
Giannis is we're listening to Giannis try to find his
he starts mumbling as
heterosexual men search for penises almost as often as they search for vaginas. And out of the top 35,000 most popular adult sites, roughly 1,000 were devoted to large penises.
So that's either just gay.
The study found that the largest audience for shemale, male to female transgendered porn, was heterosexual men. This is an erotic illusion. These are erotic stimuli that trick the perceptual machinery of the sexual brain by combining different sexual cues in novel combinations.
That's, I think that's also a big part of it is like, you know, like sexual stimuli doesn't have a rhyme or reason. You know, like there's people that like will take acid and they'll come when they see blue light.
The
like,
researchers,
you know, they're not gay because they like blue light.
Well, and then they're debunking what you guys are saying. They're saying the researchers have dismissed moral panic that argues pornography is encouraging men to pursue degrading and perverse sexual habits. Said porn was a reflection of male desires rather than a creator of male desires, and erotica generally functions to liberate and satisfy structure. Yeah, all the studies that they've been doing tend to suggest that the perception that the more you watch, the more horrible shit you want to see isn't true.
Yeah, I don't believe that. Yeah. I
well, that's just, but
that,
but in all fairness, that's just an Australian study from a couple people in Australia.
No. This is an Australian article about a study done by neuroscientists.
Two neuroscientists?
Yeah, did a study on it.
Did a study, okay.
And there's been other studies.
Well, look, I mean, listen, if people want to see that shit to just, I don't know. I mean, it's whatever you want to do.
Yeah, I don't care if you go out and do it. It doesn't bother me.
Yeah.
You don't tell other people they can't do something. That's all.
And look, I'll be honest. If I fucking grabbed a stiff one and I liked it, I'd be like, what the fuck? I'd be like,
is that a Robusta?
Hey, I would say to my therapist, I'm a little confused. Yeah, I grabbed this dick. But I mean, for me, I'm not into it.
No, I was at the deli. Why do you ask? I was at the deli. I was reaching for the chips. The dick was there.
I mean, and then something happened.
Yeah, now, mayo everywhere. I gotta talk.
Now every time I eat a Dorito, I think of a dick.
I gotta tell you, I'm starting to like it almost as much as I like Doritos.
But not the original.
Yeah, no, Cool Ranch. I prefer. Where'd you go? Where's the therapist? When did they leave?
Oh shit. Oh shit.
Giannis is.
I see Bobby right now. I see Bobby right now going, "What the fuck is Giannis doing? Why the fuck?"
My wife is calling. She's probably watching going, what the fuck are you talking about?
Oh boy. Bobby's actually in the chat room. He wants to say his top.
So I was wrong. I was wrong according to this. I was way wrong.
I fucking called it. Yeah. I knew it. You said it way too confidently.
On Pornhub. No, on Pornhub at least.
Yeah.
Pornhub,
that's a fucking huge one, no?
It's a big one.
He just gave
it's
us
a big
that
one.
Info.
Yeah, I'm just saying it ranks 22nd in the most searched.
Oh, okay.
That's pretty
See,
high.
Those
yeah.
Australians,
that's still pretty high. Of all the categories, redheads, blonde, you can go anywhere. It's 22nd.
I think it's. I actually.
And it's saying here, porn insiders know. Like they're talking about what porn. porn insiders, like the industry
is
knows.
That a job.
Like the people
I'm
who
porn
make
insider.
Porn.
I see, you know what he said? That it just. I just picture people in suits going into an office. Yeah, going, listen, you know.
I'm a
we
porn
did a study. Okay, when cum goes across all, the face, yeah. And like they're just all buttoned up.
We're all Danish scientists. How are you?
So check this out. It gets shemale's 1.51% of category views is still significant when you consider that Pornhub sees 60 million visitors per day. Over the last few years, our search and category diversity has grown, so individual types of porn are smaller proportionally. For example, the number one searched category is lesbian at 6.39, while amateur, for example, gets 2%. So it's right under amateur porn, shemale. So
well, that's I mean
that's significant.
It's great that someone who is into transgender, that's their thing, now has a category.
We got here from Boy Scouts. Just want to remind everybody. Yeah. We were talking about the Boy Scouts.
This
poor
boy who's actually a girl is actually searching for shemale porn. Can't get in.
Google analysis, Google Analytics bears this out. In a comparative analysis, shemale has 2.74 million hits. This Tranny has 450,000. T-girl has 90,000 and transsexual has 60,000.
This is like
a look.
NPR
I look at it. Look,
podcast.
I look at it. I look at it. Like,
so that's not. Like, those aren't gay guys. I mean, it's not gay.
Welcome to
those
this
numbers,
American life.
Gay guys is 1 out of 10. I think is the.
Look,
the
I think
study.
Whatever.
So just that those numbers don't add up, you know. And it's like, and gay guys just don't like transgender porn.
But that's fine. But
all right, we spend enough time.
Yeah, we should listen. Yeah. Listen. Yeah. Whatever. Yeah. Whatever people.
Whatever
think,
you want to jerk off to, jerk off to.
Right. Yeah, that's it. Whatever you want to jerk off to, jerk off to. You know. I just think all I'm saying is grabbing a dick when I'm making out somebody. Throw a wrench in my
this
evening.
Is what I'm saying.
That's all I'm
yeah,
saying.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm saying I'm attracted to femininity.
I ordered steak and there's a
wrench you didn't ask for.
I've seen some transgendered women. This is what I'm saying. I've seen some transgender women that are so attractive that like I'm attracted to them. Like
I've
I just
seen them too,
I'm
and
just
I'm like,
attracted
why is your
to them.
Body
now I don't know what would happen if a fucking
as a man.
If a horn came out. I don't know.
Yeah.
But I would assume
you
I'm because
Jewish?
I'm so horns.
Yeah.
I'm just saying I'm so attracted to it. Like, I know me. I wouldn't feel gay doing it. You know, I would just be like, I'm attracted to this person.
To you, and that's just another experience.
Yeah. I mean, and I would not feel the same way with dudes because I'm just not attracted. And in fact, some transgendered women who have masculine qualities, that's kind of a turnoff to me. If they look, I'm talking about the ones that are like fucking, he just looks like a woman. Soft
like
features.
Cox. She's really pretty.
Yeah, she's even a little masculine for me.
Really?
Yeah, a little bit.
I guess because she's really big, but she's beautiful. Yeah.
But somebody has shown me.
Not saying she's not beautiful.
And that's your thing, but somebody has shown me a beautiful.
It's not just my thing.
Somebody, no, I'm saying.
Even you guys would be attracted, but then you'd see the horn and you'd go, all right,
no. What I'm saying,
that just proves that straight guys are attracted to transgendered women.
No, it's not.
Well, let me finish.
No, because you're fixated with the femininity. That's what attracts you.
You're attracted, so straight man is attracted. Yes. To them, but until you get the horn.
Until you get the horn. It's a woman. They're attracted
until you
to
get,
you.
But that's what almost, if they got an ugly pussy when you get there? Have you ever been turned off by an ugly or smelly pussy?
Yeah.
All right. So what's the difference? Were you attracted to her before you got there?
Yeah.
All right. Point made. Now let's move on.
We've agreed with you that entire time.
No, but I saw a picture of, somebody showed me a picture and he goes, look at this. And it was a beautiful woman. And then I saw the breasts and it was beautiful breasts. And then I saw her hog and I was done.
Yeah.
You know, it was just, you know, so what?
Have you ever seen the transgendered model, what's her name? She actually got in trouble in Jezebel. Jezebel tried to get her in trouble for actually quoting Marisa in Twitter. She said, I'm trying to find a classy white nigga to pay for my tits. And Andrea, but she's like one of the biggest models in the world. And she's transgendered. If you saw her, she is so fucking gorgeous. She's like fucking Kate Moss. Fucking
no hint of a man.
Just fucking. Can you pull her up? Pedjik? She's Australian. Andreja Pedjik or something.
Okay.
Is Bobby in the chat room?
Yes. 1 second.
Is she in Zoolander 2?
I don't know, dude. She's like one of the biggest models in the world.
Andreja Pedjik.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, I'm going to question your Google skills if you can't find her.
Yeah. Oh, it's not.
Can you put it on that screen?
Throw some pics up. I'll pull up her Instagram. Well, you pull up her Instagram.
And what?
It's your background on your phone. Look at this before you see the hog.
It's a picture of me with my dick in her hand, just looking at her.
You Photoshop yourself in the background. Got one hand on the dick.
Yeah.
Just saying, there's way too much judgment going on about that shit, man.
Wholeheartedly agree.
Yeah.
I just think it's what you're attracted to.
What you're attracted to is what you're. I mean,
what you're attracted to is what you're attracted to.
Take a look at that fucking verse. Look at that.
This is right here.
Look at that.
Pull the one up in the bikini.
Yeah,
that's a man.
That's a man. Born a man.
Born a man right there.
Born a man.
Born
a
man.
But she doesn't have a hog,
huh?
She doesn't have a mule.
She had a hog. She cut it off. She decided to cut it off.
Every animal.
Not cut it off. That's rude. She, you know.
Wait, this whole time I wasn't on
she the inverted it. Yeah. Because she didn't cut it off. Okay. They invert it. They invert it inside.
But some get actually cut off, right?
Dude, the line between male and female.
You know what they do?
Scientifically is so thin. It's so fucking thin, you'd be surprised.
You would never know that that's a.
Of course you wouldn't. She's more gorgeous than most women. She's more gorgeous than most women.
Not my type. I hear you, but not my type.
You like a fat ass, but what do you want from me?
So you could tell me you could do all that. You can't put a little bubble up there? My wife and I were watching this thing about like Thailand, and of course they got to like the training. I don't know. Can you say training?
Totally okay culturally over there, by the way.
Yeah.
And they consider themselves straight.
Yeah.
So it's like you got to go outside the scope of America.
But one girl
said totally straight.
She doesn't
over there.
Have it anymore. She's like, no, they do the surgery here. It's not that expensive. She was like talking about it. Mm-hmm. And the guy asked her, does it still work? And she's like, oh, yeah, I still get wet. And that's when I was like, I kind of want to turn this thing off. I'm not against it. I'm happy.
Wait,
it's
what do you
there.
Mean she gets wet? How?
She still get like it's the guy's pre cum still comes out of her vagina, and I was like, this is like too much information.
Yeah, well, when you put it like that.
Yeah.
What's that right there?
Hey, well, who was here before me?
But I think it is worth noting in Thailand, it's an old tradition that goes all the way back. Culturally, they don't think it's weird at all. And they don't
like
think it's gay at all.
In India,
but I don't
they used
think...
to have male masseuses that would suck you off. Like that's been through culture.
In what?
In old Indian culture, they had like male masseuses that it was like straight guys would go and a male would massage you.
But they actually
and then they would suck you off.
In Thailand, they actually like they revere them because they think that they have sort of both. They have both spirits, male and female.
Right.
So they think that they're just kind of
Native Americans.
Human
I forget what tribe it is. They had five genders.
Yeah.
Like
I mean, they eat rats in Vietnam. So you know, people different strokes. For different
it's
folks.
What yeah it's yeah. what you want
it's what you grew up with
it's
too and
want.
The culture you grew up in too
yeah
it's, which affects your brain
it does
I bet if you guys were born over there you'd think differently
It's a lot of it is cultural.
You know? Maybe. I mean, and that's, again, I'm fine with whoever wants to do it.
Yeah.
I'm, in fact, I'm all for it. I hope all those guys that are secretly searching.
Yeah, I think we're all in agreement. Yeah. All right.
Go out there.
All right. I think we're pretty far into this, so I think we should wrap this puppy up.
Why don't you
up.
Tweet at us and let us know what you think?
Yeah, yeah.
What is Bob? Who's in the
if
chat
anybody
room?
Anybody has any questions about further transgender? Yeah. Just
besides
tweet
Giannis,
it.
Tweet it at me. I am
Giannis
the
knows
expert.
Everything. Yeah.
Giannis knows a Danish scientist that'll answer all your.
I'll send that link about the study that was done.
Tweet Giannis at Danish scientist.
Two neuroscientists.
Three guys
autopsies.
With a chemistry kit.
They did autopsies.
From the nephew said.
You know what's funny though is that is kind of becoming the dominant culture in America.
Is what?
Whereas like people are always like, when it comes to like studies and like empirical evidence and science, you know, it's like everyone's like, you know,
they I think just, it's also that there's so much data.
All these scientists,
you know?
Well, there's a lot of bullshit data out there, but all these fucking poor scientists that dedicate their lives to figuring
truth.
Out cures,
the truth,
truth
yeah.
Advancing technology, all this stuff that they do, the shit that they can do to your heart now, how they can save your life and prolong your life is crazy. Yeah. These guys do study after study. That's how the scientific method is. We do the study. We do studies. We do data.
We
that's what psychiatrists do.
Yeah.
We prove a hypothesis. If it doesn't work, there's a great quote by one of the physicists. I can't remember his name. He says, doesn't matter how smart you are. Doesn't matter how great your explanation is. If it doesn't add up in study, to if the data doesn't support it, it's wrong.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter how brilliant it is.
You know,
wrong.
A lot of them are saying they're going to start running for office now. There's a whole group of scientists that say they're tired of being told
it's really
that
scary,
information
man.
Isn't like real anymore.
Yeah.
They're so scared of the fact that society seems to be going away from intellectual data that a lot of them are starting to gear up to run
to
for
be,
office.
To get into, because they go by the numbers.
That's the real problem in this country that nobody talks about
lack
is how fucking stupid we are.
Yeah.
That's the real problem. Well, and you know, it's the hypocrisy of fucking Hollywood that comes out and says, we want gun control. And like, hey, there are all these liberal agendas. And then they make all these big budget fucking shoot 'em up movies where guys are just heroes, blah, blah. And everyone fantasizes, I'm going to be that good guy with a gun. I just go blah, 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 blah. You know, it's like you're conditioning these fucking morons. All these reality shows with this dumbed down nonsense.
Yep.
All these fucking shitty comedians who got like really like 12-year-old fucking jokes. Yeah. Like the shittiest fucking... And they love it. They cater to this 12-year-old sensibility.
Yeah.
You know, that's what, you know, because it's easy. The hot chick, the big tits, the fucking young hot comedian who's up there, you know, I'm farting in the elevator type of shit.
Yeah.
And then the fucking reality shows where it's drama. Hey, bitch, you said that? Fuck yeah. Fucking throw these plates at your head. And then the movies is just neck. This summer, Mark Wahlberg is in Diving Gun Guy. And then you fucking, pow, just fucking shooting everywhere.
Yeah.
And then you wonder how this happened. You wonder, and then they underfund education. We're 18th in education. I know I'm throwing a lot of stats out there.
So many stats.
But
we're 18th, just behind transgenders.
Our education, we've become so fucking stupid that people can't think. They don't know. Nobody even studies logic. What did you have a logic class? Did anyone have a logic class?
I did.
No.
I really?
Yeah. It's fucking
I'm
coloring.
I
was
wrong. I had a logic class.
Yeah, it's too. Nobody has a logic class. Everyone's fucking coloring till they're like 27. You're in a coloring class.
Did anybody
nobody
have a logic class?
Nobody takes logic. Yeah. Nobody takes fucking logic.
Who minored in
basis,
logic?
Yeah, my major. I'm minored in logic. Yeah. My majored in.
Yeah,
psychology.
I majored in common sense.
Unbelievable.
All right, so let's wrap this puppy up, see what everybody's got. Alexis, what do you have coming up to plug?
Illuminati Party is the show that I run. It's a secret location. It's in a basement, and we don't promote it. But hit us up. Hit me up at NotAlexis, and obviously Cooligans. If you guys like soccer, please tell me you guys like soccer. If you've ever even watched soccer, check it out. We're comedians first, soccer
What
fans,
is the
soccer.
Data say about what Americans like in soccer?
It's definitely not third.
it's actually second, 12 to 24-year-olds. Bam. We come in.
I was totally wrong about that, I admit.
I know a British scientist. He said soccer.
Yeah, yeah. Three Danish guys yelled goal, so we did it. Soccer Cooligans on everything. Follow us on Instagram. You'll be one of 10,000.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
That's right. That's what I said.
And you'll be the one of the only Americans who follow.
We're 80% American because I have the data to back it up because I can hit a button and it tells
me. I don't buy in data.
You got to name this one fucking data or scientist or some Danish scientist, whatever. Yeah. Luciana, what do you got coming?
I have my show at the Standing Room on next Wednesday, February 8th. It's called Fuck, Marry, Kill, and it's like the game. We play the game. We have a great lineup. 9 p.m. Wednesday, the 8th.
Well, what do you mean you play the game? You actually ask the question? Like,
yeah, so everybody like in the audience writes down the name of anybody well-known, dead or alive, and then each comic draws one. The first one, the audience will yell out, fuck, marry, or kill, and then you talk about why you would fuck, marry, or kill, or how. You would be so good on the show.
Yeah. What are you doing? My feelings would get hurt if people want to fucking kill me. Wait, so we perform and then you guys...
And then you pick two people in the room to do the other two things. So if they tell you to fuck Justin Bieber, you talk about that and then you'd kill...
I'll do whenever you want. It sounds fun.
Okay.
Wait, and then do
and
you...
And then you choose so you can like fuck... Or, you know, if they said fuck
Justin Bieber... I'll fuck, marry, and kill all trannies.
You're about to get so many emails and hate tweets.
And then you do a regular set?
Yeah, if you want. Well, actually, like one time we had Pete Lee do it and he did his whole set as the game and it was so awesome. Like he came up with stuff. He's like, I've never been able to do these jokes because you just find things or, you know, you just, who knows where it takes
how
you.
How fucking funny is Pete Lee?
He's so funny, but he killed that show.
Yeah.
Right, oh, yeah.
I would love to do a ranking of the nicest guys in comedy, you know?
Yeah.
There's like some really nice guys, but mostly shitty people, you know? Yeah.
I don't know
myself
about that.
Myself included.
I don't know about that. Shitty people? Well, maybe not great people.
No,
shitty people.
No, we got some monsters.
There's
in
some shitty
monsters.
People. Shitty people is a heavy. That's heavy.
You're right. They're that's, not murdering people.
That's,
yeah,
that's
you're
a shitty
right.
people's
you're
heavy, but.
No, the
right.
shitty,
you know,
shitty
person is the one who never doesn't still know me.
Oh, you got to tell me that after this.
I will.
Okay, so that's October 8th?
No, that.
I mean,
wait, I'm confused. What's going on? The shitty person that doesn't know her?
What are you here yet? It's next Wednesday, February 8th.
I'm sorry.
Standing room, Long Island City.
We said October earlier.
You can follow me on. Well, I mean, I have to spell out my name, but I'm sure.
It.
Just go to this.
Follow her at Lucetta! Wepa, wepa, wepa! Lucetta! Burritos!
Gatica. Gatica. G-A-T-I-C-A?
Yeah.
We did tell you she's not Mexican, right?
Yeah, I'm not Mexican.
Yanni, what you got coming up, buddy? Anything to plug?
I'm sorry I called you Mexican. I genuinely thought you were Mexican, not because I was confusing
I don't care.
You.
I have Mexican siblings. It's fine. I'm not offended.
So you are part Mexican. Oh, they're
half.
Somebody,
yeah.
All right. Well, and you're from LA, so I thought you're from LA. You're like from LA, right? Like you're from there, right?
So you thought I was Mexican?
I thought you
based
were, yeah, from
racist.
LA. I'm from LA, bro.
Are you from Queens?
I'm from Brooklyn. How dare you, Queens? Fucking
you're
Queens.
Greek, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, it's a good point. I should
what was
be.
That quiz show? And they're like, I'm from Queens. I'm from New York City. And he goes, Queens is in New York City.
Queens is brutal.
Yeah.
We're so arrogant as New Yorkers, we get arrogant about other boroughs New York.
Yeah,
right, fucking Staten Island, get out of here. All right,
I
got tour dates coming up. They'll be on my website, YannisPappas.net. I'll be at Gotham and Mar. I got a whole bunch of dates. So go check my website, follow me on Twitter, and try to catch me and Virzi smoking sticks in Soho.
Yeah. What do I got? This Friday, I will be at the Comedy Shop for my buddy James D. Benedetto at Mount Arlington. That
I'll
is at the... you will be there.
Yeah.
That is at the Courtyard Marriott. Also, February 17th and 18th, I will be headlining the Comedy Connection in Providence, Rhode Island. That's one
love
show...
That room.
Yeah, one show Friday the 17th, two shows Saturday the 18th, and a bunch of new dates coming in for 17 on my website, paulverzi.com. I want to thank Bobby Kelly and Deepu.
Yep.
And you know what, dude, podcast. You can also follow me on Twitter at Paul Virzi. And
we got a couple, just two more announcements. Follow this show, YKWD Podcast, on all social media platforms. And download the app, Robert Kelly's You Know What Dude app, on the iOS store or Google Play store. Go premium, get access to premium content. And we have Bobby's dates on the 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and 5th. He'll be at Off the Hook Comedy Club in Naples, Florida. On the 11th, he'll be at Cabot Performing Arts Center in Beverly, Mass. And the 18th, he'll be at Cherokee Casino Kuala Ballroom in West Siloam Springs, Oklahoma. So you can check those out at robertkellylive.com. That's it. Thank you, Paul. You did great, man.
Oh, thanks, man. Had a good time.
Where are you going to be, Debo?
I have
Grizzly Pear.
I could be. If I had self-esteem, I could be. next week, I actually have a couple of shows. One at Bar None on the 14th, Valentine's Day, blowing off my chick for that. So that's always a good time. And the 16th, I will be at Carmel Lounge hosting a show for my friend Kwame. Always a good time there. Yes, check those out. Dates on my Twitter, R2Deepu.
And then you'll be doing comedy in Pakistan once Trump gets fucking rid of you people.
I hear comedy's good there, so I'm excited. No soccer topics, hopefully.
No soccer.
Look, even soccer is fucking...
They love it out there. Yeah, they fucking love it out there.
All right, we're done. Thank you.
Yeah.
Check out this week's menu and get your first three meals free with free shipping by going to blueapron.com/dude. You will love how good it feels and tastes to create incredible home-cooked meals with Blue Apron, so don't wait. That's blueapron.com/dude. Blue Apron, a better way to cook.